colorful things to say on the subject.
So Mormonism's got a lot of legs to it, right? Like, people love that stuff.
And that's why this movie coming out on the 29th is so important. It's like the lancing of a boil and the laying bare of the truths of what is really an evil. It eats people, it destroys lives, and it's a horrific organization started by L. Ron Hubbard and currently piloted by David Miscavige, who, if you look in his beady black rat-like eyes, you will see into the heart of evil. I suggest looking at a picture of the guy.
So do you think that L. Ron Hubbard created this religion to suck the souls out of people or whatever it is you claimed it does?
The urban legend, unverifiable, I think it was either Arthur C. Clarke or it was supposedly there was another science fiction writer bet L. Ron Hubbard $1 he couldn't create a religion. And then 20 years later, he supposedly paid up. I think it was Arthur C. Clarke. And that's as good of an explanation for it's just a bunch of gobbledygook nonsense. I've gone into a Scientology mission and played dumb, like, oh, is this a museum? And by the end of the time I was there, they were demanding my credit card, like the woman put out her claw. It's absolutely insane. And you can't it's okay to bash Scientologists, or that's the attitude, because you're not really dealing with a rational person. They're victims, each and every one. And any sort of tolerance of Scientology as legitimate religion or any sort of organization is absurd.
What is the difference between Scientology as a religion and whatever religion you decide is legit? Because it seems as legit to me.
You've got to pay to advance in Scientology. That's a pretty big difference.
I'd say that that's a pretty big difference. But
isn't that true, Zach?
Yes. You pay for auditing, which is basically hold on to these soup cans. They call them cans. And it's a stupid little what's it called, truth detector, lie detector. It's a way of tricking the person who you're charging into thinking you have some sort of inside knowledge what's going inside their head.
Hustles exist all over in the marketplace.
Well, let me give you an example.
You asked what was different about this religion from other religions.
So they've got some little religious icon things that they use in the in their little rituals. Fine.
You could compare that to Catholic confession. That's fine. The other thing is, though, they record everything you say. And supposedly John Travolta has wanted to leave Scientology on a number of occasions, but he's being blackmailed because they have all of his auditing, all of his personal confessions over the years, all on tape, all written down, and they could destroy him at any moment. Nancy Cartwright, who is the voice of Bart Simpson, you'll never see a joke critical of Scientology on The Simpsons because she is part of their cadre, of their inner circle, and she funnels all of her money to this organization. They invent weird awards and give her medals and stuff. It's very, very kooky and very, very just – it's so unfortunate. Lisa McPherson was someone that was starved to death. She had a psychotic break, and instead of taking her to the hospital, they kept her in a hotel room for like 10, 12, 18 days until she died. And then right before the judgment was about to be set down in court, they gave like $30 million to her family, and they shut up. But like it's every religion kills people. But Scientology, it's such an obvious on its face farce that even an ISIS fighter, you could tell him about Scientology. He'd be like, yeah, that's completely ridiculous.
So what got you so interested in this, Zach?
I like weird stuff. I like to just it's so on its face absurd and false and just verifiably ridiculous that I think almost in a way it can bring everyone together. Like, we can all agree that this is a bad thing. It's been banned
from
several countries.
This bad thing, you're not going to bring me together. I think this is a religion, and I think it should be given all of the the legal value of a religion.
Doesn't that mean that it's still valid to criticize this religion and point out how it's dangerous to people and that it's not empowering them, that it's impoverishing them, brainwashing them?
Zach, should this get legal recognition as a religion?
I think if going back through the history of Scientology, two of the guys that are in the documentary, Mark Rinder and Marty Rathbun, they talk about the fight to achieve that. And that was a huge win for them because not only was it a tax thing, but it also allows them to not have disclosure about things that go on internally inside the church. Mm-hmm. I'm calling it a church myself. Go ahead. Fine. But to suggest that Scientology is in any way legitimate, like Buddhism, Christianity, all that, it's completely absurd. There's absolutely nothing to be gained from it.
Well, I think that what you point out that the people, the I can tell you, if you come to my Quaker meeting and you want to go to some kind of Pendle Hill seminar or whatever, and you can't afford it, the meeting will figure out a way to get you there.
Sure.
Because that's the kind of thing they do. Whereas Scientology, it has the sound of an organization that wants you to come up with the money to go to the meeting, plus come up with lots of other money for lots of other things too.
Right. You so, basically advance in levels, right, when you pay yep. more money.
But the generosity of an organization doesn't make it more churchy.
Can we keep talking about this?
I would like to. Sure. Hang on. But isn't that true? Like, you have to pay more money to advance in levels in the church?
A lot of money.
Right. So
you have to pay money for palm reading, for astrology, for a variety of
those are all stupid.
Yeah. Well, fine.
We'll come back with more here in moments. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. But most people don't dedicate their lives to their palm reader
or
their
know.
Astrologist.
Not sure
it's
about
Talk
that.
Live. More coming up. Share your thoughts.
By now, you may have heard a bit about Bitcoins, but did you know Bitcoins are now over an $8.5 billion market? And did you know that over 65,000 businesses now accept Bitcoins? Listen, if you're already earning Bitcoins or trying to make money in the Bitcoin market, you've got to know BidBit.co. Why? Because BidBit.co is where you can easily receive Bitcoins by selling and auctioning off your own personal items or promote business products and services for Bitcoins. You heard right. Whether personal or business, you can now buy, sell, and auction your products and services quickly, easily, and securely for Bitcoin at BidBit.co, the first and only marketplace website to offer BidBit escrow, a proprietary technology which gives buyers and sellers security and peace of mind because all transactions are protected. Start today. It's free to join, free to post, free to auction, and free to bid at BidBit.co. Buy, sell, bid, or auction everything Bitcoin. That's www.bidbit.co. BidBit.co.
Hi, I'm Derek J. To me, an activist's calling is to actively work to advance a cause. The cause for which I work is personal freedom. I believe my life is best when I engage in voluntary interactions and self-government. I reject the idea that anyone else has a higher claim to my life or my body than I do. I see people who call themselves the government as a threat to my personal freedom. I realize you may feel differently, but my relationship with the people who call themselves the government is completely involuntary. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Boost Kit Essentials Nutritionally Complete Drink, providing your picky eater with essential nutrition and great taste in one drink. Visit us at kitessentials.com. To make sure your kids eat healthy, follow the 5-a-day plan. Serve 3 servings of vegetables and 2 servings of fruit daily. Remember, a serving could just mean a piece of fruit or a half cup of veggies. If your kids are picky eaters, ask a nutritionist about other sources. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
The 3 most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are 1, share 1 episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. 2, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. 3, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Who did you let down today? Your wife? Your kids? Well, how about yourself? Take a look in the mirror. If you're tired of your drug and alcohol problem, you need to fix the problem and right now, before you hurt or kill yourself, or worse yet, somebody else. Call the addiction specialist now at the Detox and Treatment Helpline, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. If you have private insurance, we specialize in finding you the right treatment. When you call right now, you'll speak to a recovering addict who understands what you're going through right now. Let us help you break your addiction to drug and alcohol before it's too late. This call is completely confidential and free. So if you have private insurance, take 5 minutes of your time, call right now. I promise it'll change your life. 800-208-5187. 800-208-5187. 800-208-5187. Call right now. 800-208-5187.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. You dial toll-free to share your thoughts with us. 855-453. It's 855-450-3733, and you can join us online at freetalklive.com. Enjoy the features waiting for you there, free.
ExpressCoin.com is the best choice for getting cryptocurrencies. If you're looking for Bitcoins or Litecoin or Dogecoin or a variety of other cryptocurrencies, you can go to ExpressCoin.com. They make it easy, whether you're in the U.S. or Canada. They're a licensed money services business. You can get your cryptocurrencies with a money order or a check. Just start off at ExpressCoin.com. You can even do it from your smartphone by downloading their app. It's ExpressCoin.com. Coupon code FTL. You can use that to get up to $40 worth of whatever cryptocurrency you buy over there. I'm a fan of Bitcoin, but you know, other folks have their opinions too. You can get it with no fee at all by using coupon code FTL at ExpressCoin.com.
All right, we've been talking about Scientology. It's kind of a bizarre religion that really seems more like a money-making enterprise for the people who are operating it. And it's been a while since it's come up as a topic here on Free Talk Live, but once upon a time we actually used to have a radio station in Clearwater, Florida, that aired the show. And I remember one night we were talking about Scientology, and of course Clearwater is where the headquarters is for Scientology. And so there were a lot of people who were—
They got all whipped up.
Oh boy, did they. They were all over the show on that night in particular. So if you are involved in Scientology and you'd like to call to defend the religion, you're certainly welcome to do so. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Or maybe you're formerly involved in Scientology and you'd like to talk about your experience with the church and why ultimately you ended up deciding to leave. We've got Zach in Ithaca on the line via Skype. Now, Zach, you weren't actually involved in the church at any point, but yet you've done quite a bit of research into it, it seems.
Yeah, I was in D.C. with my buddy, and I'm just like, we have to go into the Scientology mission and just check it out because this is too weird to not have the opportunity to do it. And it lived up to every bizarre expectation.
Now, when you say the Scientology mission, is this one of those like reading room things where you go and then they give you their little test to see how many thetans you have? And
yeah, we did all that in the basement. So we went in, we said, oh, is this a museum? And they show us around. They told us how he was 12 years. He was the youngest Eagle Scout ever, and they showed us this weird office they have set up for him, even though he's dead. And then we went into the basement, and they gave us—
This is L. Ron Hubbard you're talking about?
Yes. Okay. L. Ron Hubbard has an office set up for him in every Scientology church and mission with all of his writings waiting for him. They have bunkers with his speeches on platinum discs. Anyway, I'm getting off track.
Weird.
So I go down to the basement. And, you know, they have, like, girls with empty folders come stand by me and, like, flirt with me, like, just pretending like they have some sort of business. It's all a huge brainwash con. Go ahead.
Yeah, that would convince me. Did you find out how many thetans you have? And do thetans come in, like, sets of 10 or 100 or what?
I took their personality test followed by their IQ test, and they just told me that I had a lot of problems and the solution was Scientology, and they wanted my credit card.
It doesn't surprise me.
Now, what were you supposed to get with the credit card? I mean, if you had whipped out the
card. They wanted me to buy this L. Ron Hubbard book about Dianetics. Commit by spending a dime. It wasn't really, because these people are under a lot of pressure from higher-ups to recruit, to get sales and stuff. And there's a gentleman, he's in the documentary, his name's Jason Beagle. Are you familiar with him? He was
No.
on the show, he's friends with David Duchovny, and he was on the show Californication. Anyway, he willingly went into Scientology, paid them money, said, I want the solutions you have to offer, blah, 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 and eventually left Scientology. And he does this 3-hour-long interview you can find, Jason Beagle, Scientology. And he describes when he finally left, he went and found David Duchovny. And he said he was halfway through explaining about Xenu and, the spirit thetans and stuff. And they were both face down on the floor laughing because it was just retarded.
Now, the Xenu thing, from what I understand about it, this is something that they reveal to only the higher-level Scientologists, the people who've paid a boatload of money to get up to, Tom Cruise level, basically. that that up until that point they deny Xenu, and Xenu is supposed to be some kind of space alien that what are they, seed the Earth or something like that? What's the story there?
Xenu is the intergalactic ruler who about 75 million years ago took all, there was an overpopulation problem in the galaxy, so he took all the intergalactic refugees, put them on Earth, and then killed them by detonating hydrogen bombs inside of volcanoes. So when you see the late night Dianetics commercial of the volcano erupting, that's what they're alluding to. And then after they were killed, there were machines that brainwashed their souls to make them forget that they were space aliens. So there's all these weird alien spirits that are wandering around Earth, lost, and they get inside of you as a person, and they rob you of your godlike powers to turn invisible, fly, levitate, turn Coke to Pepsi. And that is, so when you get clear, quote, like the road to clear, that means they've cleared out all the thetans inside of you.
These are the alien things that are, yes, they've ingested inside of you. And once they're cleared out, then you can do those things that you were saying.
Then
you can
fly. Proceed on the bridge to total freedom through operating thetans level 1 through 7. This is sounding a little Dungeons and Dragons to me.
Yep.
And it costs
the guy's a science
a
fantasy writer, no doubt.
A terrible science fiction hack pulp writer.
Well,
who just,
I mean, whatever.
I mean, it's just, you know, Neil Gaiman said that Battlefield Earth, he couldn't set it down the whole time he was reading it. But that's interesting. It just, to sum up what I'm getting at, the reason I'm so excited about this Alex Gibney Scientology documentary is that it's going to, I already know all this information, but the reaction from all the rest of the world when it gets put out there on HBO, they hired 160 lawyers to vet this movie. They're very confident in the material.
Yeah, but this Scientology stuff has been out and around for a long time. If I know it, then the average person pretty much knows this
stuff.
What
are you talking about? The average person probably doesn't know anything about Scientology.
You and I
know things about it because we've discussed it on Free Talk Live in the past, but the average person probably knows absolutely zero about Scientology.
Man, there is an internet crusade against Scientology.
So?
Yes. The thing is, you might know about it, but if you don't believe it's fascinating and interesting and weird, then you don't know enough. It's like the craziest thing ever. And
well, mostly like, what I think is that you know, there's a danger involved here. I think that religions,
danger is you lose your mind and your money.
I think that religions generally are not that much different than Scientology. We're just used to the things that they say. So therefore, you know, the things that Scientology says is new and weird. The things that religions say are old and weird. And my concern is that this organization should be a religion. It qualifies as a religion. It should get all the statuses of a church because, and when people go after it and say all kinds of stuff, many times what you're finding are not principled small government, you know, small government or no government people. What they are is people that want to see this status taken away from Scientology because they will welcome any bad thing happen to Scientology. And that's my concern.
The thing is, Scientology, when you talk about Scientology, you can't forget to mention David Miscavige. He's the man that took over the cult. He was L. Ron Hubbard's right hand man, and he is the guy running the show right now. He is a 5'1" sociopathic Napoleon complex demon person, and he is running the show. No wonder he's so close with Tom Cruise. He literally looks up to Tom Cruise, who's like 5'3", 5'4", okay? And these two, this little evil man has been able to poison the minds and the hearts and the spirits of thousands of people, has destroyed families, ruined relationships. They will help you mortgage your house to buy more of their stupid products.
I bet
products.
They will. Hey, thanks for the call, Zach. I appreciate your expertise on this matter. And I didn't hear Zach calling to, you know, pull their religious status.
But I will tell you that just about any religion out there will help you put together a way to give your money upon your death instead of to your heirs to their religion. So still, no difference. This is just a new religion.
Sure, but what he was saying was that they would mortgage your house while you're still alive to give more money to the church.
And
I mean,
what
this is a religion that's all about money. This is
you don't
all
think
about
the Catholic Church will do that for you? Will help you to mortgage your house and then become part of their organization? Perhaps they would call you a monk.
I couldn't tell you, Mark.
Yep, they'll help you do that.
Toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. Do you have personal experience with that?
There's things called monasteries all around. Yes, they will take your money. Yes, they will let you be a monk or a sister, depending on your situation.
All right, but you specifically have evidence that they would encourage people to mortgage their own homes so they could give more money to the church? More coming up here on Free Talk Live. You can share your thoughts.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges. Yeah!
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
This alert just came in. This special announcement is for business owners and leaders of organizations who've been waiting for the right time to build. General Steel has made it impossible to wait any longer with rock-bottom prices that could save you thousands. That's right, General Steel, America's leader in pre-engineered structures, is offering buildings at prices you will never see again. Don't miss these prices. A 50 by 100 for $35,000. You heard right. That's 5,000 square feet for $35,000. Manufacturers, if you need a larger building, try a 100 by 100 commercial building for $129,000. You can't afford to rent with these prices. Imagine a 70 by 100 foot church building for under $69,000. With the economy improving and interest rates still at historic lows, you can't afford to wait. So call 866-91-STEEL. Lock in your price now. Call 866-91-STEEL. That's 866-917-8335.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll-free, and you can share your thoughts with us about whatever's on your mind. Though right now, Scientology on the table for discussion. It's always interesting to talk to people who've been involved in Scientology. So if you're one of those people, or maybe you still are involved, you can call in toll-free here at 855-450-FREE. That's
call
8... Oh,
any...
sorry, Mark. I didn't
call in about
that.
Any kooky religion, for, as far as I'm concerned, because they're...
Well, there's
know,
a lot of kooky religions. There's a lot of kooky religions out there. But, you know, this one I think is particularly bad because they... extract a lot of money from their participants just to be involved with the religion. I mean, most religions, as you indicated, Mark, the Quakers, for instance, you go to the local Quaker meetings here in the Keene, New Hampshire area.
That's true.
That, you know, these guys, it's a very simple meeting. You know, they go to the, for one time it was in the YMCA, I think it's now in the Buddhist Mindfulness Center. But they don't even have their own building. They go into another.
Some Quakers do. They have a meeting house.
Okay. Well, anyway, if they have their own building, it's usually very, very simple. You know, simplicity is kind of one of the arms of Quakerism, if you will.
Yep. Tenet.
And so they're not spending a whole lot of money. They're not taking in a whole lot of money to operate their religion. But this particular religion, I've got the high cost of Scientology here from a book over at cmu.edu.
It's been some time, but I read that the Catholic Church was the largest landowning organization on the planet. I assume they're not counting governments themselves, because I guess the Russia mm-hmm. would be the largest landowning organization because they basically claim all the land inside of their area. But sort of as a non-governmental organization.
Yeah, been donated a lot of land over the years, I imagine is the case with that.
Yeah.
Sure. I mean, there's no doubt, Mark, that people that get into their religion very deeply are more than happy in a lot of cases to give large donations to it. That, you know, that's
as they should be.
Understandable. And that's, I don't have a problem with that. But to have to pay to be in a religion, period, I think is problematic. And that's not me saying they shouldn't be a religion or that they should be, you know, have their tax exempt status removed. I haven't advocated for that at all. As far as I'm concerned, they're as legitimate a religion as any other, but I just don't really care for how they go about doing things. I don't think you should be charging people to be in your religion, and you certainly shouldn't be charging them more the longer they stay in the religion. If they want to advance their knowledge in that religion. You know, normally, you know, if you have to pay for something, you pay for some holy book and then you've got what you need.
Yeah. Well, generally they'll give you one. And I agree with you when it comes to, when it comes to this, I find it distasteful. And I believe pretty firmly that a fool and his money are soon parted. That when it comes to this, that, you know, well, that's it,
well,
right?
I think that's where a lot of this is coming from, Mark. You speculated that a lot of the Scientology derision out there is from people that want to stop it from being a religion somehow. I don't know how true that is. It's your speculation. But I think a lot of it is people just want to get information out there about this religion so people can have an honest assessment of whether or not they really want to join this thing. And then you've got Scientology trying to target the critics to silence them so they don't reveal information like this. This is from a book called The Scandal of Scientology by Paulette Cooper. I found it when I was Googling for, you know, the costs involved, costs of being in Scientology is what I was looking for. One woman who quit after one session said, "It's the only church I've ever seen with a cashier's booth."
Yeah.
When people first enter.
But I would point out that, basically all religions I can think of will take all of your money if you're willing to give it to them.
Mm-hmm.
And that, 'cause that's what they do.
It's fine to, you know, be willing to give money to something you appreciate and that you like, but those religions generally don't require you to pay in order to participate. They generally don't require you to pay in order to advance in knowledge in that particular religion. That's the difference here, Mark, and I think that's important. I feel like you're trying to muddy the waters with your comments, and I want to go into this here. So when people first enter this exciting world of the totally free, they rarely realize just how expensive it's going to be. After all, the first course only costs $15, and for that price, one gets close to 16 hours of Scientology. What people don't usually realize is that they will never see this $1 an hour rate again. Later, it'll be more like $25, and sometimes more. One man who paid $1,200 in advance for a 50-hour course completed it in 20 minutes, which meant he spent about $1 a second for his auditing. Scientology has two goals and two types of courses to match, auditing people or processing, and teaching people to audit others or training them.
A lot of these people apparently can pay for their courses by working in the Scientology organization, right?
Presumably, but I'm not sure about that. I mean, it sounds believable.
Where do they get the people from? I mean, that's what we've been told on the air.
The first series on the Hubbard hierarchy, auditing or processing, consists of several courses or grades which enable a pre-clear to become a clear. If each course is taken separately, it costs approximately $750. Now, the prices are always changing, and I'm not sure at which date this book was written. To go from O to IV grade, $500 for the next one, $1,200 for grade V, $775 for grade VI6, $600 for solo, in which you audit yourself, and finally $800 for the final clear, or a total of approximately $4,625. Although package deals bring the price down a bit lower. But that's not all, since one can also go 8 levels beyond clear to achieve the state of operating Thetan 8 for only $2,850 more. An operating Thetan, by the way, is someone who can function apart from his body. An OT, operating Thetan, are said to be able to lift telephones off the hook in another room and read books while some distance away from them.
Well, this is very simple then. Let's go ahead and see one of these folks do one of their tricks, in which case, I'm in. $4,500 sounds like chump change to be able to lift a phone off of the hook in another room. So I'm down. I don't think there's any problem here at this point. As long as you get to see somebody lift a phone off the hook in the other room, you should give them that kind of money.
Well, I don't know, Mark, if they're just going to let anybody walk in and observe this.
Shouldn't give them your money.
Yeah, I agree. You shouldn't. The value of this accomplishment may not be readily apparent, but one practical Scientologist claimed she could visit her parents in Texas while her body remained in Washington, D.C. Fortunately for the travel industry, not too many Scientologists can do this. But processing or auditing is only half of the story. Scientology also trains its followers to audit others. To qualify for this doesn't even require a high school education, just another prescribed series of Scientology courses.
Why would it require a high school education?
I don't know. Probably not. Scientologists generally suggest people start with this series, and in fact, unless specifically asked, they don't even tell them about the prices of the other group until later. The second group starts at a modest $15 for the first course, $30 for the next, $45 for the third, and then suddenly leaps to a more typical rate of $1,300. It generally takes at least a couple of months to become an auditor, although Scientologists have boasted they can train some people to become auditors in less than 20 minutes. Those who wish to take courses must go to the special Scientology academies in Los Angeles, Scotland, or St. Hill and pay additional expenses for room, board, books, equipment, and transportation besides. In addition to the price of the courses, there are many other expenses. Scientologists must buy many of Hubbard's books and often attend special lectures or congresses, which usually run tapes of Hubbard or speeches by top Scientologists. In addition, a Scientologist may take extra auditing at about $25 a session or additional courses that are outside of the prescribed level of treatment or training. For example, a number of the organizers or orgs used to offer a special money processing course, which was supposed to increase the Scientologist's money-making potential. This course consisted of having the person think of a number of ways in which he could waste money, probably under the principle that one must find what a pre-clear can do and then better that ability. If a pre-clear complained that he couldn't afford the Scientology rates, he was told to take this course for only $35 to help him learn more. The money-making potential course may have helped many Scientologists, but one wonders how.
I've taken a lot of courses about how to make money that I didn't think were of much value.
One man who took it said it was so worthwhile that he made $5,000 a few days after completing it.
Awesome.
When he was pressured to tell how he'd done this, he finally admitted that after the course was completed, he'd gone to a bank and taken the money out on a loan. So there's more here, but we're going to skip through that here and just mention there's another piece that I looked at when searching for Scientology and its costs from Xenu.net, X-E-N-U.net. This is the current total cost for the whole bridge to what they call OT9. So remember, operating Thetan. This is the special levels that are above clear. Okay, so you get to clear and then you go above that.
Clear means you're just normal. After that, you can start lifting phones off the hook and travel to Texas without an airplane, right?
Yeah, supposedly. So according to Xenu.net, the current conservative total cost of the whole bridge to OT9 readiness is estimated at $365,000 to $380,000. So that's as of 2006. So those are the prices as of a decade ago. Don't know what they currently are today, but I don't imagine they're coming down over time. You can share your thoughts, your experiences with us here, whether it's about Scientology or something completely different, which is what we'll be getting to shortly. Mark, you have a story out of the world of comic books, something that you're fairly familiar with. Batgirl, apparently, there's a cover that has offended people. And so we should share the cover, I think, on our social bookmarking.
Yeah,
so
I can do that.
Folks can take a look at it. And we'll talk about it coming up here in hour number two and take your calls about whatever's on your mind. 855-450-FREE. This is Free Talk Live.
Well, I did it. I finally left the Empire behind. And now that I'm safely settled in Chile, I'm gathering with others like me to build a new community called Fort Galt. Fort Galt is designed to be the ideal home base for professionals and their families to live and work in peace. If you're ready to ditch the superstate and bring your business to freer lands, visit us online at fortgalt.com. That's fortgalt.com.
Kay Oliver is part of the Tweyambe Women's Group in Jinja, Uganda. She gets old clothes, fixes them up, washes them, and then sells them at the Jinja market. She was quite happy with her success at her business, but realized that a sewing machine would really help her make more money to take care of her two kids. Free Talk Live helped her get that sewing machine. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound, try out the subscription, cancel at any time, coffee.freetalklive.com.
LRN.FM needs your help getting our satellite signal back on in Africa. Our satellite provider had us on at no charge from 2012 through February of this year when they pulled the channel off the air. Now we're trying to raise $22,000 to continue reaching people with the message of liberty in places where it's needed most. Please visit our Indiegogo fundraiser at africa.lrn.fm. Give what you can and share the link with your friends. africa.lrn.fm.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Sunday, March 22nd, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.75 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,183 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $262. Antiwar.com reports, while the Likud party has already claimed victory in this week's elections in Israel, getting enough partners on board for a coalition government is not an easy task, with early talks indicating several factions want the defense portfolio. Avigdor Lieberman promised his supporters he'd take the portfolio after the election and wipe out the entire Gaza Strip. A poor election day showing doesn't appear to have changed his mind, and he's still demanding the spot. So is fellow hawk Naftali Bennett, who is demanding the spot and also wants Netanyahu to assure him that Palestinian statehood will not happen during the current coalition. Moshe Kalon is quite happy to be promised the finance ministry portfolio, but also wants one of his party's members of parliament to get the defense portfolio, reflecting their strong showing in the vote and warning Netanyahu that their backing is not assured. Likud wants the current major portfolios to stay in place, meaning Yalon would remain defense minister, Lieberman would remain finance minister, and Bennett, economics minister. Finance ministry is the only major spot changing hands from Yair Lapid, who is headed to the opposition, to Kalon. That's Likud's ideal, at least, but given the long road to getting a 60-seat majority, expect those plans to change and for several different proposals to be floated before everyone is satisfied. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports three South Florida police officers were fired and a fourth resigned over the exchange of racially biased videos and messages, according to officials. Fort Lauderdale Police Department announced on Friday the termination of Chris Sousa, James Wells, and Jason Holding, as well as the resignation of Alex Alvarez. A five-month internal affairs investigation found the officers had exchanged text messages using racially offensive terms in reference to black people encountered in the line of duty, as well as critical comments about the grammar, appearance, and work ethic of black co-workers. The investigation began when Alvarez's ex-fiance came forward with evidence. Dozens of pages of messages revealed text advocating violence towards blacks, while others featured derogatory comments towards Hispanics and homosexuals. According to investigators, Alvarez created a mock video trailer called The Hoods, which featured images of a KKK hood and President Obama with large gold teeth. Fort Lauderdale Police Chief Frank Adderley said the officers worked in a predominantly black community. The Fraternal Order of Police said in a statement on Friday that it is a multicultural organization which does not tolerate racism, but added that everyone is entitled to due process and that these officers have a right to a fair review of facts.
FPP Radio News is brought to you by Coinbase. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. I trust Coinbase. You should too. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. That's coinbase.fppradio.com. Reuters reports Iran's top leader voiced mistrust on Saturday of U.S. efforts to reach a nuclear deal, even as Washington and its allies spoke of real progress and urged Tehran to make difficult decisions. With just 10 days remaining until an end-of-March deadline for a framework agreement, Iran's supreme leader Ayatollah Ali Khamenei denounced U.S. bullying in the negotiations and repeated Tehran's denial that it was seeking to develop a nuclear weapon. After week-long talks with Iran in Switzerland, U.S. Secretary of State John Kerry flew to London to confer with his counterparts from Britain, France, and Germany on prospects for resolving the dispute, which goes back more than a decade and has threatened at times to unleash a new war in the Middle East. In a joint statement, the foreign ministers said they agreed that substantial progress has been made with Iran in key areas, but some important issues remain outstanding. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
In Baltimore, the streets have gotten safer thanks to the success of the new Permanent Daylight Initiative, which aims to prevent crime by illuminating the entire city 24 hours a day using high-powered floodlights.
It's just that it's so bright all the time, even in the rain.
City officials say there have been zero violent crimes since the start of the program, except for one man who vandalized a light by throwing his body off a building into it. Now let's set our crosshairs onto Mountain View, California, where Gmail servers were down for nearly 2 hours today. In an online statement, the company said, "Tremble before Google. With the mere flip of a switch, we can bring you to your knees." After reestablishing service this afternoon, Google changed its logo and released a statement saying, "If not appeased with a 20% increase in Google Chrome downloads by the next vernal equinox, they will take back their generous gift unto mankind of colored conversation labeling." All right, you can take off your helmet. You have survived the news blitz.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live, you can dial toll-free to bring up anything that you want. 855-450-FREE is the number. That's 855-450-3733, and you can join us online over at freetalklive.com. We talked a lot about Scientology in the first hour of the program. If you have something to say about that, you're certainly welcome to join us here. Also, DC Comics, there's a comic book cover that I guess just came out very recently, Mark, that's stirring controversy, and you would like to discuss that tonight. We'll get into that. But first, we go to Clayton. He's on the line in Arkansas. Hey, Clayton, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, I just wanted to give a shout-out to the Arkansas State Legislature for voting or for killing a bill that would have regulated e-cigarettes and vaporizers in the same way as tobacco is currently regulated. And nice. I think that was a good victory for liberty, really, and a good victory for the new businesses that are coming into existence because of e-cigarettes and vaporizers and that sort of thing. I mean, nothing needs to be regulated like tobacco is currently regulated, but certainly, we don't need to try and kill new businesses by adding things to that list.
Right. I mean, to me, it's just absolutely ludicrous. The best thing they seem to be able to come up with vaporizers is they look like smoking, and it confuses people.
The children, right. Also.
Whomever. I mean, well, the children haven't seen anybody smoke indoors.
Well, I mean, they also will say that, you know, they smell pleasant, so that will attract children. You know, they smell like fruity, for instance.
Uh-huh. Well, I'm sure that there's some young people that use vaporizers, but the young people that are going to smoke, too. And what are you doing? Vaporizers just make it less likely they're going to do that. I mean, yes, nicotine's a poison. However, it's like only one poison out of 1,000 in a cigarette or some number like that. I don't know exactly what it is, but there are quite a few poisons and carcinogens inside cigarettes. There's like one in vaporizers.
That's right. And it you know, so far the best, you know, the best sort of medical argument is we don't know what effect these vaporizers will have on public health. So we're going to regulate it like something that we do know whose effects it has on public health. I mean, there's not even a good comparison there. That's not to say it wouldn't be great if we, you know, cut back some of the regulations on tobacco products, but, you know, certainly it makes no sense to be taxing vaporizers and applying the same sort of restrictions on vaporizers for something that is a completely different type of access to the drug, nicotine.
Yeah, I don't know what to do about this, but it seems like that this is the way things are going, is that, you know, what appears to be, for all, from what I can tell, the much safer alternative to inhaling the combusted plant material of the tobacco plant. That, you know, just somehow people just they just can't stand it. The, you know, the do-gooders out there just can't stand somebody having a good time, and it just makes them irrational.
Right.
Clayton, thanks for sharing that tonight. Anything else on your mind?
I mean, I work at a grocery store, so I sell cigarettes all day. If you were trying to enact, if you said, okay, we're going to enact an income tax on the poor, just the poor, because, you know, we're all about middle class. We're going to enact a tax on the poor. You would never get it passed. But to attempt to, you know, taxing cigarettes, this is my experience working at a grocery store. The more you tax cigarettes, the more you are taxing the poor. Yep. It is nothing else but a form of middle class warfare to enact further regulations and further taxes on things that for the most part are a cheap thrill for poor people who can't get bigger thrills, you know, from more exciting drugs. So, you know, to me, it's absolutely an example of class warfare. It's absolutely an example of the thing that we need to be getting rid of in the name of liberty and in the name of supporting the small businesses that are coming about because of vaporizers and because of innovation here.
Good call tonight, Clayton. Appreciate hearing from you. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. So I understand, Mark, there's a proposal for similar legislation here in New Hampshire. Hopefully it will go down in flames as well. But I feel like, I don't know, did it actually pass the House? I feel like I don't know. Yeah, I know that it's going to be heard, I think, coming up this week. Maybe it's actually being heard in the Senate and hasn't gone to the House yet. If somebody out there has paid closer attention, please feel free to call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. It's hard to keep track of all of what's going on in the New Hampshire State House.
Yeah, it's really amazing. Once these things get in place, how you just get used to it. When I moved here to New Hampshire, you could smoke in bars and restaurants if the bar and restaurant wanted you to be able to do that. Mm-hmm. Then at some point or another, some little busybodies at the State House managed to get that stopped. Now, I got to say, I like it better, right? Like, I can go in more places and it bothers me less, but I still think it's a property rights violation. But I can't even imagine what it would be like now. People, you know, I mean, to turn this back, I can't imagine what it would take to turn it back. Like, it is done.
To reapply freedom in that area,
yeah.
You mean?
Yeah. It would be really unlikely.
Well, I mean, what it's going to take, Mark, is for 20,000 people to sign the statement of intent for the Free State Project. We've got over 16,000 now. We want to get to 20,000, and then those 20,000 people, it's going to take them moving to New Hampshire, and it's going to take them getting active in whatever way they feel is most appropriate to, you know, try to achieve liberty in our lifetime. And part of that will involve getting elected, as a number of Free State Project participants have already done. We've got over a dozen Free State Project participants who are in the State House. I think the official number is like 15 or 18, somewhere in that range. There's quite a few, considering how early on the Free State Project is. After we've got 10,000 people here, there are only about 1,500 movers so far. After 10,000 of them are here, then I think that's going to help change things in the right direction. If you've got 100 free staters in the state house, that may be enough to actually turn this thing around. So I think it can happen. It's just not going to happen in most places. It's not going to happen outside of New Hampshire, likely. But if it can happen anywhere, I think this is the place where it is most likely to occur. But we've got to get thousands more liberty-minded people
here. You probably
would
have said that about marijuana legalization, too, right? Like, you thought that New Hampshire would be the first one to be able to pull that off.
No, I don't think I would have said that.
No?
No. I mean, obviously, California already had medical back in 1996, and that was before the Free State Project.
And their medical was very lax.
Yeah, that was before the Free State Project even was an idea. The Free State Project didn't come around as an idea until 2001. So, I don't think New Hampshire is going to be the first to go legal in the Northeast, either. But that's not the fault of the Free State Project. It's just New Hampshire's system is fairly difficult to change. And so it's difficult to add government in New Hampshire, but it's also difficult to
subtract it,
to remove it. It's a double-edged sword. Let's go to someone who's anonymous in Gardner, Massachusetts. You're on Free Talk Live.
Hi, how are you guys doing tonight?
Good. Go ahead with your thoughts.
Yeah, I can't give my name or anything because the case is still going on. Thursday night, I was driving from one end of the state to the other after. I'm a disabled American veteran, war veteran.
Okay.
I won't say what branch or anything else. And I'm also a former police officer, never been arrested in my life. The state I'm in has state police. And I'm also a diabetic. And I went to visit my friend to go to the DAV to meet people, you know, to be a veteran and get help for different things. Because I'm a former veteran. I walk with a cane. I'm a wounded warrior. I was driving home, and I was pulled over by the state police, asked to get out of my vehicle, said I was swerving all over the road, going a speed limit that I know that my vehicle cannot go because it's not in great condition. I was treated like a common thug criminal. Mm. They did the breathalyzer on me, and as you know, Thursday night being around here, it was very extremely cold. Those things have to be calibrated to the weather, and I'm pretty sure they weren't calibrated. And the other thing, too, is if you're a diabetic, diabetics make acetone in their bodies, and it comes out of their, comes out of their lungs, the acetone.
Okay.
And that will make a diabetic, if they had one beer, it will make it seem like six beers.
Hmm. As far as the breathalyzer goes?
Yes, the breathalyzer.
Okay.
And also with the blood test, you cannot get a proper reading on somebody with diabetes because their bodies make acetone.
Mr. Diabetic, stand by. You can tell the rest of the story here in moments. I didn't know those things. 855-450-FREE. More coming up on Free Talk Live.
I have a 70-pound Royal Standard Poodle. Her name is Zelia. And 3 years ago, Zelia's ears were a mess. She would have sticky, gooey, smelly discharge in her ears. We took Zelia to the vet 7 times of $150 every time. The vet offered no success at all. My wife and I are driving, and we hear some people on the radio saying D-I-N-O-V-I-T-E.
859-428-1000. The omega-3 fatty acids.
Flaxseed, zinc, alfalfa.
The digestive enzymes that are cooked out of regular dog food.
6 days after I started feeding her Dinovite, my dog's ear problems were cured. My dog no longer yelps. She can be petted without pain, and it's because Dinovite made our dog healthy again.
859-428-1000.
859-428-1000.
DINOVITE.com.
Gold, it's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common-sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2233 for the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
If you want to move to the Free State and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. Do you want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin, any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too? Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, the live Sunday edition. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Coming up, a comic controversy that Mark will be explaining to us, but your calls will also take them about anything you want to discuss. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Don't forget, we've got Skype. You can Skype into the show at username lrn.fm. And if you care about privacy on the internet, then you probably already know you've got to take steps to make sure you get privacy on the internet. By default, you don't have it. Your internet service provider's probably logging every website you visit, the search terms you enter, they're logging those too, maybe keeping those logs for several years in some cases. Also, you might just be having your packets sniffed, as it is called, when somebody might be using a packet sniffer to determine what some of your login information is, if you're connecting in an insecure manner to certain websites. So that can be done as long as you're on a Wi-Fi connection, so your laptop or even your cell phone is subject to being sniffed. If you want to stop those things from happening, ProXPN can help you right now. You just go to proxpn.com/FTL, and you can download their software. It's available for Windows, Macintosh, iOS devices, Android, as well as Linux. You download that, get it rolling, and you'll be protected because they encrypt your data connection. And it's a virtual private network, global. You can connect to different locations around the globe if you subscribe to their premium package. Plus, you get unlimited bandwidth and the ability to privately torrent, as well as get past regionally blocked websites when you upgrade to premium by using our code FTL50, which gives you 50% off the price of the premium account. It's a yearly price break, by the way. You have to buy the annual package. FTL50 is the code over at proxpn.com/FTL.
Plus, you get a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee, so there's nothing to lose except for your privacy. Oh yeah, and ProXPN does not keep records of your online habits at all. So go to proxpn.com/FTL, use promo code FTL50, and get a great discount on privacy that is priceless. We've got an anonymous caller in Gardner, Massachusetts. You said that you were pulled over in Massachusetts by the state police. You are a diabetic, and you say that because of your condition, that if you drink one beer, it'll make it look like you had six. And you would your former law enforcement, and you were shocked with how the police treated you in this instance.
Yes, I'm a veteran of one of the previous wars. I'm a young man.
Okay.
And I walk with a cane. I hurt my leg very bad during the war, so I walk with a cane. My balance is also bad. So I was pulled over. I had two beers, two regular-sized beers. Didn't have a lot to eat that day because, like I said, I was in the other part of the state at a DAV function, Disabled American Veterans function. And being a former police officer, I wouldn't drive under the influence anyways. But a lot of diabetics need to know this information across the country because a lot of diabetics are being arrested for DWIs, and they don't realize it, that it's their a lot of it's their diabetes. Because, like I said, a diabetic makes acetone, which comes out of your lungs and shows up as alcohol on their breathalyzer machines, even their hand one that they use in the field for sobriety, and also the one at the station. They have to do two on you.
So what if you say, I'm diabetic? Does that just void the whole thing?
They don't believe you. And you know, if you say that to them, they add other charges on, so they're going to get you for something.
Really?
It's really a bad.
Has it worked in court? I mean, obviously, saying it to the officer is not going to do anything. At least I wouldn't expect it to. But do you know of cases where diabetics have actually beaten DUI by going to court and then showing, hey, you know,
only
you can't.
I'd say out of 100 people, 40 have beaten.
And why is it? The jury just doesn't believe it, or what?
No, the state wants to make revenue. You know, I'm a former cop. The state wants to make revenue.
Yeah.
The judge won't. You know, and the other thing is, a lot of people are scared because the judge holds a lot of power. They bring that up, and the judge is like, oh, you're trying to outsmart me? Then I'm going to add this on to your thing. And it's a sad fact. And the other thing, too, is I want to let people know is, when you get pulled over for a DWI, and they make you, you know, do the sobriety test on the side of the road, walk one foot in front of the other and everything. Well, first of all, with mine, they took my cane away.
Oh,
there was
boy.
No
Jeez.
Way I was going to pass.
Sure.
There's no way. But the second thing to know, because I'm being a former police officer, is you could try this at home, or you guys could try it where you guys are at right now. You cannot pass that. That is a test to add more evidence for the police officer's case, but it is unpassable. You can't pass it. You
the
have
line
to be like
walking test?
Yes, you have to be one of the Walindas, tightrope walkers, to be able to do that. It is a test made to fail. And I'll even, what you do is you put one foot in front of the other.
Yeah.
Then you stay with one foot in front of the other one for about 5 to 10 minutes. It's impossible. You can't. No one
5 to 10 minutes is how long it takes to do this test?
Yes, that's how they do it. But yep. usually people, and a lot of times the roads are uneven and stuff, and you're doing this sobriety test on the side of the road. And, you know, it's just. It's,
so they arrested you, and you're facing.
Yeah, they arrested me. They booked me. I told them I was having a diabetic attack. And, you know, they were like, yeah, sure. And I
yeah,
said,
we hear
know,
that all the time.
Yeah, that type of thing, you know, with whatever, you just want to get out.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, it's either that or you guys are going to have some, I said, you guys are going to have some serious legal matters on your hands because I'm going down soon. I can tell. You know, a diabetic can tell.
Well, yeah, I mean, yeah. I mean, they're supposed to let you have. I mean, if you're a diabetic, they're supposed to let you have access to your medicine when you're in custody, is my understanding. And you may have yourself a case there.
Well, what they did is they sent me an ambulance. The man in the ambulance, the paramedic, you know, they put me on the stretcher, probably, and they checked my blood in the ambulance, and my blood was 398, almost 400. If it gets over 400, you're going in a coma. My blood usually runs at about 80 to 90, normal.
So why did they hold you in a holding cell this long, or what happened?
Yeah, they held me. I had to keep telling them.
I see.
Well, I mean, you know how it is, Mark. I mean, when they book somebody, it's an hours long process at the very minimum, even if you're able to go and bail someone out. I want to say good luck. It sounds like you may have a good case to possibly sue the state police in this. I hope that you find a good, I don't know, I guess an accident or injury attorney, or maybe even a criminal defense attorney who can help. Well, I mean, you may not need the criminal guy to bring a suit. Is what I'm saying. So good luck and thank you for the call. Feel free to update us over time. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. More coming up here. DC Comics, there's a comic book cover,
yep,
I guess, that has stirred up controversy. It's being talked about in various different places on the internet. Mark, you've got the story about this, and you are not even a DC fan.
Not really, no.
But yet you're upset here about this comic book cover, or at least the reactions.
A lot of people certainly are.
You're upset about the reactions to it, not so much the cover itself,
yeah.
Right? All right, so we'll share some of those with you here in moments. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, and Mark has already shared said comic book cover on our Facebook, Google+, and Twitter, so check that out there and share your thoughts with us here on this live Sunday edition of Free Talk Live. More coming up.
So who else will you meet at the Get Prepared Expo? For starters, from Republic Broadcasting, John Moore and John Statmiller. From GCN, Aaron and Brad Dakins, Joyce Riley, and me, Vincent Finelli. Joining us are the instructors whom you've learned to trust. Surgeon of the Year, Dr. Norman Shuley. Engineer, Matt Stein. The real Fox Mulder of the X-Files, Dr. Richard Allen Miller. Author and analyst, Captain John Reagan. Your counterterrorist from Central America, Mike Ma. Dental center owner and my dentist, Dr. Howard Shane. Radiation instructor, Craig Douglas. Author and survivalist, Rich Sheban. Author, Judy Dollarhite. Cancer center owner from Mexico, Dr. Patrick Vickers. Bug out expert and pilot, Captain Bill Sermo. Beekeeper, Jeff Maddox. Seedsman, Mike Knox. Author, Gayla Pruitt. Author, Harry Cooper. Food expert, Joe Acapinti. And Bill Whaley, the junk man. March 27, 28, and 29. GetPreparedExpo.com, the largest preparedness and survival expo in the USA.
Are you looking for an excuse to come check out New Hampshire this fall? You're invited to Keenvention. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year's keynote speeches and panels will be announced via the Keenvention blog and Facebook, so stay tuned there for the latest. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 30th through November 1st. Tickets are available now at a special early bird price of just $50 via credit card or Bitcoin. That $50 price only lasts through the end of June, so don't delay. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more and look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
In every age, a technology is created that upends the foundations of society. The wheel, the printing press, the internet. Now, in a world sliding into financial chaos, a new technology is changing the way monetary systems work around the world. It is called Bitcoin. Bitcoin is a new form of money controlled not by banks, governments, or corporations, but through mutual commerce between free individuals. To learn more, visit weusecoins.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com. Free Talk Live's recent Bitcoin sale was a big success.
so we decided to extend the 50% discount through April 17th.
Free Talk Live was the first ad venue in the world to accept bitcoins for ads. We love the concept of a value-based digital currency that allows people to actually control their own money.
We introduced Roger Ver,
Bitcoin Jesus,
to Bitcoins, and here's what he said.
Free Talk Live is the premier voice for the peace and liberty Bitcoin will bring to the world. By broadcasting this message since 2011, Free Talk Live has been instrumental in creating the widespread adoption that we have today.
If you need some advertising for your business, website, or organization, and you want to save half off, send me an email right now, mark@freetalklive.com.
This is your chance to save 50% on national radio and podcast ads. Just pay with Bitcoin. Email mark@freetalklive.com. That's mark@freetalklive.com.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live, the live Sunday edition of the program. You can dial toll-free and join us here to talk about whatever's on your mind, 855-450-FREE, whether it's Scientology, as we discussed in the first hour, or this controversial comic book cover that we're going to get into here shortly on DC Comics' Batgirl here in moments, 855-450-FREE. Also, Skype in at username lrn.fm. Let's jump to your calls and talk to Tony, listening in New Jersey. Tony, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark.
How you doing, guys?
Tony, go ahead.
I want to bring this up. The American Code of Law states that in every court of law in the country, you have the right to be represented by counsel. Mm-hmm. However, the family court has found a way to avoid that. So when you go in a family court, especially with a restraining order, you cannot get a public defender because no crime has been committed. But even though there's no charge, you could be incarcerated up to 18 months because once you're in a family court, all they have to have is probable cause. So they use the court like a military tribunal, and the accusatorial form of law, which is the American Code of Law, innocent till proven guilty, that does not apply. Just the mere fact that there's probable cause.
What are people getting incarcerated for, though, in family court?
I just said example would be, let's say, a restraining order. Somebody accuses you. In American Code of Law, you have the right to stand before your accuser.
Right.
So now you're accused, you're in the court, and the judge is the inquisitioner. He says, I don't believe you. I believe A or B or whatever. So probable cause, in his subjective opinion, doesn't have to have any prima facie evidence. His mere opinion determines.
So it goes beyond giving out a restraining order? It goes to incarceration?
Oh, it's common, Mark. I mean, if somebody violates a restraining order, they go to jail.
So it's the violation of a restraining order.
Yeah, they go to jail. I mean, if you get an order, it happens all the time. I know a guy here in Keene who had, you know, one of these orders against him, and then his wife or his ex-wife, I guess, you know, contacted him. And, of course, she's allowed to contact him, but he can't respond. And so they, I guess what the situation was, she wanted him to get together with her so they could, there was some sort of issue with some houses in New York, and they, you know, they were selling the houses, and they both had to sign some paperwork. And so, like, they had to get together. So they met secretly at a local restaurant, signed the paperwork. And then during the meeting, they received a phone call from the school. Apparently was, you know, one of the kids was sick. Something was, you know, happening at the school. So they both, without thinking, rushed to the school together. And then someone in the parking lot saw them together, called Keene police, and then Keene police arrested him for it. So even though she didn't even complain about him violating the order, he was still, you know, put in handcuffs and taken to jail over that.
It's called an arrest no drop policy. An arrest no drop policy. Here's the big picture, though. There's a motive to this. Hitler once said, who owns the children owns the future. Who owns the children, the fathers will follow. So now when you have the children, millions of children are on Prozac. Prozac can only be made from a chemical that comes out of the nuclear power plant. It's the waste of aluminum that makes the same chemical that goes into sarin nerve gas goes into Prozac. Hmm. The FDA approved the Prozac. The FDA has no business approving a nuclear element. That's in absolute RICO law statutes.
Well, the FDA isn't doing anybody any favors by existing in the first place. I mean, they are a government monopoly that actually restricts innovation. I mean, if somebody wants to put the byproduct of a chemical process, whatever that process is, in their body, they should be able to. They should have the freedom to make that choice. And I don't think that the FDA or the doctor should stand in the way. So I'll disagree with you on that point. But you're right, Tony, about the family courts. They're absolutely terrible. And I thank you for the call tonight. There's just so many different problems that come out of that. And also, Mark, you'll go to jail if you don't pay the alimony, for instance, or the child support. If you get behind too far on that, they'll go ahead and put you in the clink. That's where our friend Russell Canning was. When in 2010, I was arrested with a dozen people. We call ourselves the Trespassive 12, just simply for going to the jail and trying to walk around and look in the windows and find our friend. He was in there for non-payment of child support in that case. Which, of course, how are you going to pay the child support if you're in jail?
I think what's more interesting about the Trespassive 12 is that you guys had gone previously just to the jail on multiple occasions. This was a new location, and they sort of changed the rules on you without being giving much time for you to make your decision. They gave you some time.
No, they didn't. Nope, not at all. They came out and they announced to a large group of people, about maybe 70 people, they came out. One of the guys who works for the jail, who has the nickname Mumbles.
Yeah, Mumbles. That's hilarious.
He's a nice guy, but he's just not very good at projecting. He comes out and addresses the crowd and says something like, you know, you got to leave, the cops are coming, or whatever. I didn't hear it, and a bunch of other people didn't hear it. So ultimately, we had no time, because by the time we'd walked around the jail another time, the police rolled up as we were walking into the parking lot, just sort of on our own. We were getting ready to leave, going to go out and have some dinner. Mm-hmm. And then we're walking into the parking lot, literally going toward our cars to leave, when Keene Police walks up and just arrests everybody. There wasn't even a warning for us. And of course, that defense in court didn't hold water for almost all of the defendants, except for one. And the reason why one defendant was successful and the other close to a dozen people were not is because there was a different judge in the one defendant's case. So all of the facts and the circumstances of the case were identical, but one person was found not guilty while the others were all found guilty, including myself, because the judge was different. So it just really shows how arbitrary things can be in a courtroom when all the facts are the same, but you change the judge and you get a different outcome. We could probably take family court calls all night long. I mean, there's just so many just horrible abuses of human freedom that come out of these family courts. They're just absolutely terrible. You can share your thoughts with us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. I hope no one ever has to experience these things that I know, but unfortunately, already some people have, and it's just terrible.
Yeah, I'm no fan of the court system, the family court specifically, but I don't know what anyone can really do about it. It's sad to see.
I'm sure there's some kind of reforms. I mean, I know that there's the sort of the abused fathers movement, if you will. I don't know what they exactly call themselves, but you know, basically the dads who've been screwed over by the family court system, because it does tend to have a heavy bias towards the female in any kind of a couple's breakup. I imagine those guys have some specific suggestions. If you were to talk to them, they could probably tell you a few different things that would make things more fair than they currently are. But, you know, how do you get traction to make those things happen? Well, that's going to take some time. So, Mark, let's go to DC Comics. What's going on, the controversy, and where's the story from?
Well, I've got several stories pulled up, but this one from Newsarama. Apparently, the title here is DC Pulls Joker variant to Batgirl cover after controversy emerges. So
They pulled it.
So this cover, which I'm looking at here, which has the Joker holding on to Batgirl, basically looks like he's holding her hostage and kind of...
He's got a gun in one hand, and then he's poking her with in the cheek with his other hand.
He's kind of smearing lipstick on her face into the Joker smile.
Oh, that's what he's doing. I wondered why she was all bloody looking on her face. That's lipstick, huh?
That's the idea.
Ah.
But this article starts with, and I think it might be a little biased, the internet wins again!
Okay, so they are obviously against this particular cover.
It seems like a lot of people are, and this comic didn't sell a lot of issues, so I'm going to go ahead on a limb and say the vast majority of people with opinions didn't buy this comic.
All right, well, we'll come back with more here in moments. 855-450-FREE. Why is this so controversial anyway? It's Free Talk Live.
Hey, it's Mark of Free Talk Live, and I want to tell you about a new way to be prepared for emergencies. Not just big emergencies, but little ones too. It's a source of backup power, so small that I can put it in my pocket or the glove box of my car, but it's so powerful that it can actually jumpstart a bus if I need it to. Sounds crazy, but it's not. I'm talking about a breakthrough in portable power technology called the Pocket Power Plus. If you get stranded in an airport, in your car, or you just want to go off the grid for a while, the Pocket Power Plus becomes your own personal mini power plant. Run pretty much any kind of electronic device for hours, even days if you need to. The Pocket Power Plus can also deliver an enormous supply of on-demand power that can jumpstart almost any vehicle, even the coldest winter days. Comes with free jumper cables and an accessory pack. Best part, my listeners can now get Pocket Power Plus for half price by going to PocketPowerPlus9.com. That's PocketPowerPlus9.com. Use coupon code FTL to save even more. Go to PocketPowerPlus9.com, PocketPowerPlus9.com, coupon code FTL.
By now, you heard about Bitcoins, but did you know that over 65,000 businesses accept Bitcoins? Listen, if you're already earning Bitcoins or trying to make money in the Bitcoin market, you've got to know BidBit.co, because at BidBit.co, you can receive Bitcoin by selling your personal items or business products. You heard right, whether personal or business, you can now buy, sell, and auction your products quickly, easily, and securely at BidBit.co. That's BidBit.co. BidBit.co.
It's no secret that government and big business buy in bulk and get huge discounts not available to the little guy. Until now. Introducing a breakthrough crowd buying website where people can join together, buy in bulk, and get massive discounts on millions of popular products. It's TogetherSave.com. TogetherSave.com. You can save 20, 30, or even 50% off tablets, smartphones, cars, appliances, textbooks, sports equipment, video games, and much more. All with free delivery. Check it out. TogetherSave.com. Visit now and start group buying today at TogetherSave.com.
Delighted Health Insurance executives gather in an outdoor coliseum to watch a patient battle cancer, and a self-conscious flasher is fully clothed under his trench coat. This is the Onion Week in Review. While stressing that they would absolutely never consider doing anything of the sort, German leaders quietly admitted this week that they were pretty sure they could carry out another Holocaust if they ever truly wanted to. Quickly noting that the Holocaust was an atrocity that should never be repeated, no matter how easy it would be to do so, almost all members of the German parliament discreetly conceded that with their country's dominance of Eurozone GDP, pulling off the unthinkable genocide would not be the least bit difficult.
I'm just saying, hypothetically, that we very easily could do it. I mean, we definitely have the infrastructure, and the concentration camps are still standing.
In other news, a so-called Christian has an erection. A new study finds more children are growing up in single-parent households, and a real-life Nancy Drew traces the source of her HPV.
This is the Onion News Network.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. So what is the big deal with this comic book cover? Mark is going to try to explain here using an article from, where was it again?
This is from Newsarama.
Newsarama. And I've never heard of that before. So we'll get into that here in a moment. So there's a cover of Batgirl, which is fairly recent issue. Number 37, I guess, 2015.
They're saying 41 here.
41?
Yeah, okay. But I've seen 37 printed elsewhere.
Well, fairly recent.
This is just more proof that the people who have a problem with this Batgirl cover
don't know what
aren't reading the Batgirl issue.
So, yeah, I want to know more about it. We'll also want to know from you what you think about anything that's on your mind. We are here on the live Sunday edition. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. So let's continue in here, Mark. What do you got to share?
Yeah, so real quick, I just want to mention that a comic book that gets, 50,000, that 50,000 issues are purchased is a pretty well-received comic.
Okay.
A variant cover is a percentage of that, then, maybe 10% or whatever, will then get the variant cover. So this is a variant cover that got pulled. And
meaning this isn't the default cover for the comic?
This is not the default cover. This is just another cover. And it's a way to sell more issues.
Okay.
If it's going to be an important issue, you make variant covers that way.
And then the collectors buy twice.
Three times sometimes.
Yeah.
Right. So there you go.
So do they show what the original cover looked like?
I didn't even go looking for that, and didn't expect you to ask me that question, so I'm not ready for that.
Okay.
But I'm just pointing out that if there are 5,000 copies, if there that were made, 5,000 copies were intended to be made, that would be, in my opinion, about how many people get to have an opinion on this. I think you can have an opinion on something you don't purchase, but
your opinion can be that you don't want to buy it because your opinion is, not positive.
Yeah, but you weren't going to buy it anyway.
Maybe you would, but you were so offended by the cover.
How would you have ever heard about it unless it was the controversy in the first place?
Well, maybe you're a fan of the comic and
So you want to go swing out and get issue 41?
If you're a fan of the comic, you're buying the comics.
But you're buying
it already.
Hold on, Ian. I'm saying that if you don't purchase the comic regularly, you didn't purchase this issue, maybe even you did.
Isn't it possible someone who is a regular buyer could have been offended by this and therefore did not buy the comic?
They would have had another cover that they could have purchased if that's what they wanted to do.
If the other cover is at the store at which they purchase, right?
A variant cover is going to be something that you're lucky to get a hold of.
Okay.
So this isn't it's not likely that you'd be at a store and be forced to purchase this mm-hmm. cover. So, this is just kind of, I don't like a picture on the internet. There was a few months ago, there was the Milo Manara Spider-Woman variant cover.
I don't know what that is.
Okay. Milo Manara is an artist who is known for his naked girls. And he drew a picture of Spider-Woman who looked like she had her costume painted on as opposed to having it, wearing what is a skin-tight costume that all superheroes generally wear, right? Like the default costume for a superhero is a skin-tight costume.
Okay.
But this costume went well beyond that to, look, I think some artist spray-painted this, airbrushed this on her. Then she was in a position that was supposedly, ridiculous. But Spider-Man's in ridiculous positions all the time, too. So, there's this this back and forth between women in comics are over-sexual and video games. Women in video games and comics are over-sexualized.
But that's not what this is about, right? I mean, I'm looking here. She's not dressed in lingerie or something like that. So what is it that's offensive? I want to get into the article. I'm not real sure what's offensive about this.
I don't know
the context.
Because of the negative online response, DC has pulled its variant cover for Batgirl 41 at the request.
Does that mean they pulled all of the copies of the comic off the shelves?
That they could get.
Wow.
But I don't think they're going to get them back anyway.
Now they're going to be worth a lot of money.
Right. They're not going to get them back anyway. What comic store is going to give it back to them? What distributor is going to give it back to them?
Well, I don't know. Are they not obligated to turn them over or whatever?
We sold them all.
Okay.
I mean,
yeah, I would certainly say that if I were in charge of the comic book store, because then I'd sell them on eBay at 10 times the price.
Having worked at a comic book store for 6 years of my formative years, mm-hmm. I can tell you that when we were there, and I'll grant you this was in the 80s, it's not like Marvel and DC knew what we had sold at yep. any given time. So I suspect any comic book store, and frankly, any distributor, if Diamond's still around, you know, anybody in the warehouse is like, oh no, that's not going back to DC.
Yeah.
And they're going to grab it, and it's not going anywhere. I mean, this is on eBay.
I'll sell that sucker.
Yeah, this is a pull in name only.
Okay.
Because
okay. Gotcha.
You know, I guess the copies that they have won't go anywhere, which is to say that the people at DC will then steal the comics out of the building,
and then
sell them elsewhere. Right. So anyway, let's go on.
Right. Yeah. So you barely even started this thing. This article was like, it's a victory for the internet, and we got one sentence in. So go ahead.
Yeah. At the request of the covers artist, this artist is, let's see, another one of these. I read what his name was. But anyway, he was.
As though the internet has some sort of collective opinion about things, and as though the internet believes one way. I mean, it's ridiculous.
Yeah, the internet is a way for people to get a hold of, you know, it's a communication tool. And yeah. certainly there are some people that are unhappy about this cover. It's got a picture of. You know, Batgirl with Joker is holding a gun, but the gun is a phallic symbol pointed between her breasts, and he's smearing lipstick across her. You know,
is this
face.
Actually what you've read? Is this what people are saying?
That oh, you want me to read it to you? Yeah, I've got
yeah,
that
I
too.
I want to know what people are saying about this. So he's holding Batgirl with a gun, pointing downwards. He's touching her face, sort of making almost like a gun, you know, like a gun with his
gesture.
Hand, almost.
Yep.
And she looks terrified.
Yeah. This Albuquerque is the artist's name. And he said, oh, yeah, go ahead and pull it, because he didn't realize it was going to create all this kerfuffle. He was just trying to do an homage to Brian Bolden, who I believe is the greatest artist in comics history. He did a lot of Judge Dredd, of which I'm a fan, and he's done a lot of DC, of which I believe is something slightly above scat porn. I just, you know, find DC to be dreck. And I'll really never forgive him for not doing any Marvel covers. But that's fine. That's his career, not mine. So anyway, he goes on. The image drawn by Brazilian writer Rafael Albuquerque from The American Vampire was one of the 25 variant covers DC is releasing in June as part. Oh, in June. Well, I don't know. Comics tend to have a date that is farther ahead. So maybe this is just never going to get done. I don't know how they found out about this cover without it being released.
25 variants on one comic?
Well, if it's an important issue.
I guess. Okay.
It might be like the, see, 1988. I don't know. I thought it might be an anniversary of The Killing Joke, of which this cover is an homage. Anyway, going on. It's the 75 celebration of the 75th year anniversary of The Joker. The image depicts the Joker holding a terrified Batgirl hostage. Albuquerque says, for me, it was just a creepy cover that brought up something from the character's past that I was able to interpret artistically. And he was referring to the 1988 graphic novel The Killing Joke, in which the Joker shot Batgirl. But it has become clear that for others, it touched a very important nerve. I respect these opinions, despite whether the discussion is right or wrong. No opinion should be discredited. No opinion should be discredited. Love that. That's taking a stand. The Batgirl, the 41 cover was the subject of the negative reaction from online fans, supposedly fans. When it was released on Friday, blogs and tweets questioned the image of Batgirl being terrorized by the Joker, given that the character was previously paralyzed and sexually assaulted by the Joker in The Killing Joke. Like, sexually assaulted might be a push, right? Like, there were pictures taken of her in her underpants. I wouldn't call that a sexual assault.
I read something. I mean, I can't claim to be knowledgeable about this, but I am on IGN.com, and there's an allegation here that in a graphic novel or in a novel or something that she was
The Killing Joke.
That she was raped by the Joker.
You could come to that conclusion if that's what you wanted to come to, but that is not what Miller or Bolden, the author and artist of that comic, said. And I read that comic, and there was no rape that I recall.
Hmm.
I mean, I could be wrong. I haven't read Killing Joke in some time, but you know, being refreshed by the author and the artist here, it says that wasn't the case. So going on.
I'm still trying to really grasp this. So people are upset about this picture of the Joker essentially holding this girl hostage because they've had past history together. Is that the concern? Is it
the concern is
he
is
did
that
something bad to her in the past, and now
the concern is that this might be a triggering cover, right?
Oh my God,
that's
really
what it's about. It's about somebody might be triggered that there's a rape conversation that goes on in, as a subtext.
This is ridiculous. I mean, it's just a
right. Well,
it's a scary cover. I mean, she's supposed to. She's, I presume, in jeopardy in the comic, and that's what's on the cover. I just,
well,
I'm shocked by this.
I you know, comics have a long history of not showing you what's going on in the comic on the cover, mm-hmm. so you got to be kind of careful of that. But you know, I mean, yeah, she has been in jeopardy by Joker in the past. It also goes to show the very importance of the crime of rape over the importance of, say, the crime of assault. Because I can tell you that there are heroes being assaulted on a regular basis, male and female, on covers of comics, mm-hmm. whereas this is because it's triggering. That's the reason it gets pulled.
And I would love to hear from you, listeners, how you feel about this. 855-450-FREE. Is there more, Mark? Because we'll cover that.
Oh, yeah, lots of it.
On Free Talk Live.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write WORMS in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
In a trial by jury, the primary function of a juror is not to dispense punishment to the accused. It is to protect your fellow citizens from being unjustly deprived of their life, liberty, or property. As a juror, you can say no to unjust laws and prevent government abuses of power by refusing to convict. Legislative, executive, judicial. The fourth branch of government is we the people. Find out more from the Fully Informed Jury Association at fija.org.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write WORMS in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates. Online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Thursday, March 19th, 2015. Gold opened today at $1,165, down $10. Silver opened at $15.92, down 7 cents. And Bitcoin is trading around $259.50. Today's Bitcoin price is brought to you by ExpressCoin, the fastest, most reliable way to buy Bitcoin. Buy Bitcoin today at ExpressCoin.com. In the news, officials with the U.S. government have announced they cannot find more than $500 million worth of U.S. military aid given to Yemen. The Pentagon admitted to losing the whereabouts of small arms, ammunition, night vision goggles, patrol boats, vehicles, and other equipment provided by the U.S. Members of Congress have been attending closed-door meetings with military officials in an attempt to hold someone accountable. The Pentagon has suspended all shipments to Yemen. According to a review of federal data, the Obama administration has set a new record for censoring files or blocking access under the U.S. Freedom of Information Act. The Associated Press studied requests to 100 federal agencies during 2014. They found an administration that takes long periods of time to respond to requests and often claimed no records existed or refused to release records until they were challenged in court. The U.S. government spent about $28 million on lawyers' fees to keep records secret. Nearly 40% of all requests were denied. Protesters with the Blockupy Alliance battled with riot police early Wednesday in Frankfurt, Germany, at the opening of a new headquarters for the European Central Bank. An estimated 7,000 people rallied and fought with the police, who threw tear gas and fired a water cannon. Around 550 protesters were detained, 94 police officers were injured by stones, and 7 police cars were set on fire. Support for the Liberty Beat comes from CoinArch, offering innovative trading solutions for Bitcoin. Do more than just buy and sell Bitcoin. Use long and short positions to profit in rising and falling markets and boost your returns through leverage. Visit CoinArch.com and sign up using coupon code MAX and get free brokerage for the first 7 days. Looking to promote your business or cause to tens of thousands of loyal listeners? Well, for a limited time only, the Liberty Beat is offering you the chance to say big while spreading your message. It's simple. Just sign up for 3 months of advertising and get your 4th month free. Don't miss out on this unique opportunity. Just visit thelibertybeat.com/advertise and use coupon code GCN in the Describe Your Company section. This is the Liberty Beat for Thursday, March 19th, 2015. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. On Wednesday, a group of parents of the 43 missing Mexican students appeared in Houston as part of a tour across the United States. Protesters gathered with the families outside of Houston's Mexican consulate, holding signs and chanting. The protest was in solidarity with the families, who have not seen their children since they went missing in September of last year. The parents are planning to travel to New York on April 28th to ask the United Nations to investigate the human rights violations in Mexico. Law enforcement and government officials have been suspected of working with local gangs to murder the students. Researchers in Brazil have published a long-term study in the Lancet Global Health Journal that claims breastfed babies are more likely to turn into well-educated and higher-learning adults. The researchers from Brazil's Federal University of Pelotas followed close to 6,000 babies from birth into their 30s. Around 3,500 of the participants volunteered to be interviewed and take IQ tests. All of the babies who had been breastfed were of higher intelligence, had spent more time in school, and earned higher wages. The Liberty Beat is sponsored by Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. Support also comes from the Texas Bitcoin Conference. Hear from speakers like Charlie Shrem, Dr. Robert Murphy, Vitalik Buterin, and Catherine Bleich, March 28th and 29th at ACL Live at the Moody Theater. Tickets on sale now at TexasBitcoinConference.com. Use coupon code LibertyBeat for $25 off your ticket. That's coupon code LibertyBeat. This is the Liberty Beat for Thursday, March 19th, 2015. Remember to check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan reporting, reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
The FBI has successfully executed a raid on the Visa Corporation, exposing what could be the largest credit card scam in U.S. history. According to authorities, the Visa Syndicate for years fooled millions of Americans by issuing convincing-looking credit cards carefully designed to dupe consumers into spending far more money than they had. Investigators believe the fraudulent corporation also lured victims in with enticing rewards programs and free gifts, thereby trapping them in a spiral of debt they could never hope to repay. According to the results of a groundbreaking new study, 96% of humans would rather be a singing, dancing, animatronic bear. The study finds that a great majority of people on the planet would prefer to trade in their regular lives for one in which they sat on a plastic log, strummed a banjo, and sang songs on a stage with all their goofy bear friends. Respondents also stated that not being a sentient human being with feelings of doubt, sadness, and pain contributed to the decision.
This is the Onion News Network.
We are back with hour number 3 of Free Talk Live. Time, of course, for you to call in. Bring up anything that's on your mind. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. With you in studio, you've got Ian.
And Mark.
And Mark, you've been telling us about a controversy, which I just don't really understand it. Why it is people are upset about this Batman cover, or excuse me, Batgirl
There's a Batgirl cover where I guess they're saying this hasn't even come out yet. You said it was the June edition of the comic series.
Yeah, I'm not exactly certain of that. I'm not a DC fan. I really don't pay that much attention to Marvel either. I mostly buy the compiled graphic novels if I'm going to read stuff. I just prefer that as a system for reading comics.
Yeah. So anyway,
and this I don't read DC.
Comic cover is a variant, and apparently there are going to be 25 different variants. So one of 25, some people found very, very offensive. It's a picture of the Joker holding Batgirl, sort of keeping her hostage, if you will. He's got a gun. The gun is pointed downwards across her chest, and he is sort of poking her in the cheek and appears to be spreading red ink across her face. I thought it was blood when I first saw it, but then you pointed out it was likely lipstick or something like that, some kind of red he's spreading across her face in a sort of a Joker-esque smile.
Yeah, the Joker wears makeup, right?
Yeah. And so people are finding this offensive. Mark, what you explained to me from, I forget, news something.
Newsarama.
Newsarama.
There are a bunch of stories out on this.
Was that people seem to, the people who are offended think this is a trigger, meaning that people who see this cover are going to relive their rape experience? Is the idea?
That's, I think, one of them. Like, lots of people have lots of different opinions, and once you start asking people about opinions in which they have no financial stake, which is my largest complaint here, is that you probably shouldn't get to have an opinion if you don't have a financial stake.
Oh, I can have an opinion if I damn well want to have an opinion.
I get it.
I will.
I get what you're saying, but I mean, as a business, why do I care?
No, if you're selling comics and I'm not a buyer, then yeah, you really shouldn't care about what my opinion is.
But I have been forwarded this story that it takes us. I have yet another story.
Well,
that
hold
takes
on, hold on to that, because we got Brian in Keene, New Hampshire. Is this Brian Sovereign?
This is Brian Sovereign. Hey guys.
Hey man, why'd you bail on Skype? You had called there first.
Oh, my phone Skype was weird. You know, Microsoft. They're just wonderful.
Ah, okay. So what's up, dude? Go ahead.
Yeah, I heard you talking about this DC story, and I actually am quite a DC fan. I know
you wear those darn Batman shirts into the studio. I've let you go on the air in them, so I think that's pretty big of me.
Yeah. Well, so this whole thing, I really think. I mean, I know a lot of people want to talk about it because of the, you know, implications of rape culture and whatever else, and triggering of it. But, you know, I got to say, as someone who, you know, I've been called and I've often even identified as a feminist, but I think this is just nonsense. There was a similar situation that happened in November of last year where there was a Spider-Woman, not Spider-Man, but Spider-Woman cover where her butt on the cover of the comic was, you know, like apple shaped and it was really, you know, really pronounced. And her was like, oh, I can't believe this.
Her costume looked painted on.
Yeah, exactly. And, you know, really, it was the case for Marvel back in November, and I think it's the case for DC right now, that this is hype. This is what they call, in showbiz, what they call cheap heat, where you set up a story. I mean, because, you know, you got to understand, a lot of these, like Newsarama and even like Jezebel, and you take your pick of the online journalist or blog source, whatever, you know, they're not making a whole ton of money. And I think a lot of times what's happening now these days is that these companies, you know, whoever, you know, DC or even the gaming companies, they're making up these stories like somehow that it's a big deal just to promote and get extra sales for the comic book.
So you think DC was in on this?
The conspiracy theory.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I think so. And here's the thing is that it's ridiculous that people are complaining about this, you know, the implications of what this comic book means, you know, due to what it means to Batgirl. But then nobody's complaining about the fact that this is coming out in celebration of the 75th year of the Joker. So people, if they were really like concerned about sending out bad messages and triggering messages, people should be freaking out about the fact that a villain is getting highlighted as woohoo celebrating, you know, they're celebrating villainy. In fact, a madman at that. So, you know, really, the whole perceptions are just totally skewed. So, personally, I think it's just a good old-fashioned marketing ploy. Mm. You know, this is common in wrestling. I mean, that's how that whole industry works. And comic books are a little different, I think. It's just a way, you know, it's like And they do this a lot. Take, for example, when Superman died back in the 90s.
Yeah.
You guys remember that?
Yes.
Vaguely. I mean,
it was a big news story, and they got play on regular news stations, television news stations.
Right. Okay. So they got it was a huge story in the 90s. It was a big deal. But what most people don't realize is that just in the previous decade to that time, and I think that happened in like 92 or something, or 91 maybe, whenever that death occurred.
Seems like it was later than that, but okay.
Yeah, I feel like it was later.
Yeah, maybe it was a little later. But Superman, the previous decade, was dying 2-3 times a year in the comic books. it wasn't like Superman dying was a big deal. He's died constantly, over and over again. He had died. And in fact, it would even carry on to the next issue. You didn't know if he was going to come back to life. So DC just, went into hoops, with news sources to make it a big deal. And I think that's all this is. I can't believe that people are really freaking out over a dramatic retelling, which is what this, what this cover
But people are freaking out over it. I mean, even if DC is this is just a marketing ploy, it's a successful one because there are a lot of people coming out on either side of this.
Hmm. Sure, but the thing is, the internet kind of skews what reality is as far as how many people are really mad about something. Take for example, Gamergate. I think you guys have talked about that recently.
Did our best.
Yeah. Gamergate is this notion that somehow a bunch of teenage boys want to kill female gamers and female developers. And that's insane. I mean, it wasn't that long ago that I was a teenage gamer. I would love for women to be involved in gaming. Yeah. And for them to, even come over to my house and, hey, yeah, let's rock out some games. It's all to create this. I know it sounds conspiratorial, but really, I think it's all just to create this heat. And just to give people, clicks to go to these websites that really, they have nothing interesting to talk about at all.
Well, it worked for us, I can tell you that.
Brian, thanks for the perspective. Appreciate hearing from you tonight. The toll-free number, by the way, that was Brian Sovereign from Sovereign Tech. I should mention that. Does a great tech show on at least a weekly basis. It airs on, obviously, through his website. I think that's sovereigntech.com, SovrynTech.com. You can also catch it on LRN.FM. He does a great job with that. And they cover other stuff besides tech, like, geeky stuff like comic books.
Yep.
So, I mean, if we're supposed to actually believe that the Joker holding Batgirl hostage on a cover is somehow going to trigger people's concerns with rape or their memories, the bad memories with rape, then maybe we should also just make sure no one ever takes another woman hostage in any kind of media ever, because, I mean, that could trigger, right? Like, what about, King Koopa taking Princess What's-Her-Name in the Mario games? I mean, could that trigger maybe some bestiality fears and rape together?
Well, I mean, okay, so it's a little bit of an argumentum, whatever. It's an absurd argument in the sense that, Joker did have this history from 1998 with this, situation where,
But the average person doesn't know that, right? I mean, the person who looks
at
that
cover. It's an homage.
This
cover is an homage to that comic, though.
But wouldn't you have to be, so what you're saying now to me, Mark, is even more bewildering. What you're saying now is that this cover would only trigger the people who knew about the comic from the 1980s.
The Killing Joke.
The Killing Joke.
Which is one of the greatest comics ever written. I mean, it's right up there with The Dark Knight.
People who are familiar with that comic enough to know about what happened with Joker and Batgirl back then, 20 years ago almost.
Right.
And who also have been raped.
Well, I suppose you could be triggered if you hadn't been raped, if you were just like really worried about it all the time.
I guess I just don't understand the triggering thing. 855-450-FREE. There's more coming up here. You can share your thoughts. This is Free Talk Live.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's
the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
Hi, this is Mark Edge, host of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the very economic engine that powers this country. With a printing press tethered to Washington politicians, bureaucrats, and central bankers, how can we put our trust in paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Come see gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold. With Washington, D.C. delivering more debt and printed promises, common sense tells us the future of the trend is obvious. Everyone listening should visit gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938. I trust Midas Resources for my gold, silver, platinum, and you can too. Again, I want you to have this book, and it's free. It's gold.freetalklive.com or 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com. Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
I love my Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found my Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, you dial toll free to bring up whatever's on your mind. The number, 855-450-FREE. And that is toll free. You can also connect with us on Skype, which also will not involve a toll. You can Skype in at username lrn.fm with you tonight, Ian here.
And Mark.
Trying to understand the controversy surrounding this comic book cover, it now seems even more ridiculous than it did at first, because what you had said at first, Mark, was this comic book cover on Batgirl with Joker holding Batgirl hostage is somehow triggering people with the rape fears, or people who have been raped into reliving their experience, I guess, the horrifying experience that that must be. And I don't, you know, I don't want to take that lightly. I understand that that's pretty serious, but at the same time, If it all it takes is a comic book cover to trigger that, I find that kind of hard to believe, especially when what you said further was that the only people who could really be triggered by this cover are the people who know that in the past, Joker, back in the 1980s, allegedly raped Batgirl in some comic, although Mark, you say that didn't happen.
Well,
I thought I read somewhere that in a novel of some sort that it may have happened.
Okay.
So maybe, you know, it was in a book or something like that.
No, okay, it's a graphic novel is what they call The Killing Joke. It is a thicker than normal comic book.
Okay.
So a graphic novel is a nice way of saying comic book. I don't have a problem. I don't have any baggage around the term comic book. So I don't, you know, I mean, if you want to call your comic book a graphic novel, fine. We can call your comic book a graphic novel. But to me, I'm not saying anything bad when I say comic book. So some people see it that way. They see it as a lesser art form. I don't. But
the only people who could have been triggered by this then would be the people who knew about the alleged rape or the molestation.
I don't think that's necessarily true.
Okay. So then you're just saying that people who see a picture of a guy holding a girl hostage could be triggered by that and
they
think
could.
That that somehow links to rape?
Well, I think that literature needs to stop with all the trigger warning stuff. Like, we need to step back and say, well, wait a second here. What is all this about trigger warnings? Because at some point or another, it just goes, it's gone too far, right? Mm-hmm. I mean, like, you need to, whatever your problem is you need to get over it and deal with real life at some point, and the rest of us need to be able to get our entertainment however we get it. Because I've been beat up. What if I get a trigger? What if I'm triggered by superheroes being beaten up on the cover of comics? So, I mean, this happens constantly.
Yes.
Right. So being beaten up is, and I'm not talking about a little bit here. I've been beaten real good.
You know, that's happened to me in the past, and I don't, get all upset when I see violence happen on screen in a movie or, walk into the comic book section of a bookstore. And I guess if that's something that you deal with, and again, I don't want to, if you're traumatized or whatever, maybe you shouldn't be reading comics with violence in them. I mean, if violence traumatized you, whether it's rape or an assault or whatever it was that happened to you, a family member was murdered, I mean, I don't know what happened. But if it's something that's bothering you, then you shouldn't encounter things like that. You should make a point of not reading comic books because you're going to have situations with hostages. You know, you're going to have fights happen. Characters are going to perish. You know, things like that. Movies, the same thing's going to be the case. Just, stick with romance novels or something. I don't know.
Well, maybe the romance novels trigger too. I don't know.
Yeah,
but you see, this is the problem, is you cannot make art for everyone.
That's true.
You just can't do it. It's not possible.
I want to bring Richard on the line here. I know you had another perspective from a different article you want to share on this, Mark, with this controversial comic book cover on Batgirl. Go ahead, Richard. You're in Omaha.
Yeah, I was just listening, and it brought back a lot of memories about comics, and where especially at one time in the 80s, Nancy Reagan at one time, I believe it was, had wanted the comic book industry to deal with certain perspectives of life with people. Like, one had like a mental breakdown, and you said rape, and other perspectives for a series, just to put it in context, but involving superheroes and how they deal with anything that had happened to them, and all for background for a series.
Comics have long been used as a tool to address certain social issues. Like, Captain America took on the Falcon back in the 70s when the whole civil rights and riots and things like that were going on.
I can go even farther back than that. When they first started out, they were like detective stories, pure detective stories from the 30s through the up to the 40s, and then you were reading a detective story, and then it was Franklin Roosevelt that said, "Oh, he doesn't want kids to get scared." So that's when they started turning it back and changed the perspective. But it was so funny that what you remember reading in a comic book as a kid almost comes out to be true. Like, I remember one thing when that Quick Draw McGraw cartoon comic book came out, and they were saying that they were going to all of a sudden have taxes on people breathing air and all for it. And look how close it's coming to these days for the air.
They're almost there. Thank you, Richard, for the call tonight. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. There are some states that will tax water, like, you know, you can't capture water on your own property.
They claim to own
instance.
It, yeah.
Yeah. All right, so what's this other perspective you wanted to share, Mark?
So,
and where's it from?
This is from io9.com.
Okay.
And the image also suggests, by its very content, Batgirl crying, powerless, and at the Joker's complete physical mastery. Evidenced, by the way, he's touching her. Regardless of what it's an homage to, the tone could not be less appropriate for the current Batgirl of Burnside comic. Now, Batgirl has been upgraded to the sort of new millennium girl superhero thing, much more powerful than females had been used in the past. So Batgirl was, you know, at some point, basically a professional hostage like Robin.
Okay.
Right?
Meaning she was rescued by Batman?
On a pretty regular basis. You would agree that Robin and Batgirl, Robin at one point in the comics was basically there to be taken hostage so that Batman could be upset and try to do something about it, right?
I've never read them, so I couldn't tell you.
Okay.
I'll take your word for it.
I mean, you can almost imagine.
That sounds plausible.
Young boy in green underpants runs along with, bizarre billionaire and gets taken hostage by a bunch of lunatics, right? Like your big, large array of costumed lunatics.
Yeah.
It's a silly story, but Batgirl was essentially that. Robin in with two X chromosomes.
So how did she end up being Batgirl? I mean, was she his girlfriend or something?
No, Batgirl was the daughter of Commissioner Gordon,
the cop.
Yeah, and I don't know what the origin story is of her off the top of my head, but I'm sure she was wronged in some way or another.
Gotcha.
And she certainly, like Robin, got her fair share of licks in on the bad guys.
Yeah.
Mostly, it came down to kicking the butts of the henchmen, and of course, the main superheroes get to kick the butts of the main supervillains, and that's kind of how these things go. Now, you're asking me to defend storytelling, ordinary storytelling, on the side of DC, which I consider to be garbage comics from the get-go. So, that's difficult for me. I really first recommend kids read Marvel. Just read Marvel. Don't stray into DC.
I want to hear more from this story here. It sounds like they are also against the cover.
Oh, yeah. No, nobody seems to be for it.
Free Talk Live.
Attention, listeners. SurvivalLife.com is giving away free EverStrike permanent matches for a limited time only. These matches are waterproof and will light in any weather condition, rain, snow, or sleet. It will still throw a spark. It's built-in ferro rod, strikes at 3,000 degrees, and it is good for 15,000 strike. Normally, $15. Today, it's free. Get yours at freewaterproofmatch.com. Again, that's freewaterproofmatch.com. Hurry, supplies are limited. Visit freewaterproofmatch.com today.
This is David Cordani, CEO of Cigna. For more than 20 years, Cigna has worked with the March of Dimes to address premature births in the U.S. Thank you for taking time to learn more about how you could support March for Babies in 2015. Premature births cause horrible suffering and cost billions of dollars each year. That's why Cigna is committed to raising funds and awareness through our employees, family, and friends to improve the health of moms and babies. Please join us in supporting the March for Babies. Start your team today at marchforbabies.org.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. Hey! That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market.
The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross may be spending the rest of his life in prison. His family is planning to appeal his conviction, but they need your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Ross needs your help now more than ever. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Hey, I'm Ian Freeman, one of the hosts of Free Talk Live. I created Free Talk Live in 2002 as an alternative to traditional talk radio. I wanted a show where anyone could call in and bring up any topic without fear of being screened out. Combined with our libertarian, voluntarist viewpoints, Free Talk Live is a unique syndicated radio show heard on FM and AM radio stations, coast to coast and beyond. I moved from my birthplace of Florida to New Hampshire in 2006 as part of the Free State Project. I'm also the program director of LRN.FM, which I launched in 2009 to create a place to present the best liberty-oriented audio programs from around the globe. I perform liberty outreach of all sorts and have done civil disobedience, non-cooperation, and run for office multiple times. Much of that's covered on my blog at freekeen.com. Thank you for listening to our shows. And if you want to support our work, please visit amp.freetalklive.com and contribute just $5 a month to our effective liberty outreach. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.FM.
Free Talk Live. Of course, you can dial in toll free to bring up whatever you want. We're talking about a controversial cover for the Batgirl comic, which honestly, I've never read any DC comics, I don't think, in my entire life. But Mark, and I don't think I've really ever read any Marvel comics either, except for maybe Transformers. I read some Transformers when I was a kid.
Was that a Marvel?
Yeah, they did. Yeah.
Title. Yeah, as a comic book guy, we didn't take Transformers or Star Wars very seriously as comics.
Why is that?
They weren't part of the universe, as it were. Yeah, so they were outside of the canon.
They never did a crossover with the Transformers.
They probably
or something else?
Did.
I bet you they did.
I'm sure. I mean,
so wouldn't that have made them part of the universe?
No,
at that
it
point?
Wouldn't.
No,
sorry.
I mean, if Wolverine shows up in a Transformers
it's
comic,
not good
that's
enough.
Not, no. Okay.
Superman's shown up in a box of Wheaties. What difference does it make?
Yeah. So I mean, there's more here, and we'll get into it. But also want to let you know about an interesting opportunity for liberty-minded folks who are looking for another place to live.
Well, live or just have a vacation place or an investment or whatever. It's FortGult.com. It's in southern Chile. What they're doing is they're setting up this, I don't know what to call it precisely. It's not some kind of a sprawling valley full of vast estates or anything like that. It's more like a condo building or a ski resort, and they've got some pretty cool common amenities like a maker space full of tools, a restaurant, a bunch of places to relax and socialize. They sell very small sort of condominium units, and then they'll, as I understand it, they're going to be renting them out. So you'll essentially be buying a share in their Liberty Hotel, as it were, and the accommodation are affordable. They're just a little home base outside of the country. There's only room for about 100 people, so don't wait until the place is full because you'll, you know, regret it. It's FortGult.com. You do owe it to yourself just to go see the videos and the presentation over there. I think it's amazing.
It's very unique, I have to say. I can see this would be very, very attractive to folks. The price points are within reason of the average person could possibly afford this.
You could buy it as opposed to renting. And, you know, they're very small units. I think that the smallest one is something like 4 feet by 11 feet. It's, almost a cell, as it were. But it's, you know, it's nice accommodations, and there's plenty to do outside of the room. Mm-hmm. It's basically just a place for sleeping and getting a little quiet.
Right.
So there it is. FortGult.com. It bears mentioning. It's summer in Chile when it's winter in the United States and Canada. FortGult.com.
Okay, so Mark, you're sharing with us some opinions of people who don't like this comic book cover with the Joker holding Batgirl hostage
They're saying it's triggering people, meaning that it's triggering people who are maybe they've been raped in the past because apparently the Joker might have possibly sexually assaulted Batgirl in some comic in the 1980s, and that somehow people would know that when they looked at this comic book cover.
It is one of the most important comics probably ever.
Okay, so you were just beginning to kind of share with us something from io9.com.
Yeah, so this is the claim here is that this is not the Batgirl of Burnside, which is a fun, not dark, has many female readers, especially young ones. So Batgirl's been rebranded away from the professional hostage that she was back in the day when she was sort of first created to this new sort of sprightly, fun, young adult sort of comic that's aimed at young women. And it shows, I guess, the inappropriateness of putting this cover referring back to that time on that comic, if that makes sense. Like, you might say that your Transformer comics that you read in the past, if they would have splashed a picture of Elektra with a open cleavage and, wearing nothing but a bikini or whatever on that comic, it might have been a little more than the people who are normally consuming that Transformers, or at least their parents, are ready for them to see. Hmm. You get what I'm saying? So it might be inappropriate in that way. And I think that that's the most convincing thing I've heard so far.
Is that what they're saying at IO9?
At IO9, they're saying something that basically this is not appropriate for the audience that is consuming Batgirl today. Moreover, and which I don't read Batgirl today, and I have no interest in reading Batgirl. A rebranded Batgirl for tween girls holds no interest for me. I don't read DC. The last thing I read from DC was Native Son, and I can't tell you how old that thing is. I don't read young girls' comics either. It's not for me. I think it's great that they're creating comics.
Yeah, I didn't even know they made comics for girls.
For young girls. I mean, this is, I think it's wonderful that they're doing that. And they're doing a lot better than they did back in the day of sort of creating the black heroes. The black heroes didn't, it was really difficult for them to take. I always felt like Falcon was the best of them. But they had Luke Cage, Power Man, who'd run around going, "Sweet Christmas!" and saying ridiculous things like that. And they'd have Black Panther, who I felt never got a fair shake, but he was a king. And I don't think that a lot of people could really, connect with him because he was a king. And so that wasn't really a thing. But he has a remarkable similarity to Wolverine, and Wolverine took off like the Dickens. He's got metal claws. Wolverine's got metal claws. Mm-hmm. Whatever. So, I don't know. I never understood why it didn't happen. Anyway, moreover, it's incredibly sexist. I would hope even the most bitter of woman-hating male comic fans. You think that fit into his category here?
How is it sexist?
He's going to tell you. Would surely have to agree that a male superhero, unless he was a child, would never be drawn crying while held hostage by a supervillain. And I'm racking my brain trying to figure out when this has been done before. Because Batman certainly cries over Robin being held hostage, right?
Ah.
I wonder if Robin has cried being held hostage. That's a possibility, right? Mm-hmm. And we you can't discount what Batgirl's role in the comics were at the time as professional hostage. So is that...
Okay. I just want to real quick say, so again, I am not a follower of this, but when you mentioned the last critique that you said was the best critique, that this comic cover did not fit with the style of the previous issues of different Batgirl comics, I did pull up dc.wikia.com where they actually show you about a decade plus worth of comic book covers, and I'm looking only at 2014, so just to see what is some of the recent comic book covers. Now, while there are some covers where they're kind of cutesy with here's one with Batgirl with her cell phone, and she's kind of smiling, and she's taking a selfie. Like a selfie or something like that.
Batgirl selfie.
There are some that are sort of like that. There's another one with her on...
Hashtag supervillains.
There's another one with her riding a subway, and she looks relatively calm there. But then there's two, volume number 31 from July of 2014, June of 2014, and I haven't gone back further than that, but in June of 2014, there's somebody named Ragdoll who actually has her with a knife to her throat, on the on the cover here, and this looks like a fairly kind of intense situation. They're clearly fighting with one another. There's another one with the Midnight Man, a new nightmare, it says. There looks like this horrifying beast is attacking her. This is a very scary looking cover. This is not like, you know, something you'd necessarily expect a 7-year-old to be reading or something like that. So I would say that I disagree. I mean, based on the covers I've looked at, there are certainly some covers where Batgirl is in conflict with either men or creatures that are threatening her life, and they look scary.
Ultimately, she probably fights them off, and I'm sure she does in this issue, too.
Of course.
But this variant cover, which is among like 25 different variant covers that were out there, I guess they're saying these things just get some legs and they take a life of their own, where a bunch of people who, like me, who were not going to buy the comic, suddenly have an opinion about the comic.
May of 2014, I mean, there's three in a row here. May of 2014, there's like a scary red-eyed wolf at the top, and then two masked-looking assailants, one with a knife, another with a sword, actually one with two knives, slashing at Batgirl, and they appear to have her at odds. I mean, she's down. She's two against one here.
Right. Who wants to buy the comic where the hero is winning on the cover, right? You know, there needs to be conflict. There needs to be a chance for the villain to win. Of course, the hero always wins at the end of the comic, and I'm sure that's what's going to happen here at the end of issue 41 in Batgirl.
So, more coming up here. You can share your thoughts. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Is there anything to this except for that people are super sensitive nowadays? Or maybe Brian Sovin was right and this is all just a plot for publicity. It's Free Talk Live.
How fast are new Allegra gel caps?
I didn't know you got a cat fast.
How strong are new Allegra gel caps?
10 more lots to go strong.
Non-drowsy Allegra gives you noticeable relief of your toughest allergy symptoms in just 1 hour. 2 times faster than Claritin and stays strong for 24 hours.
It's relief when the pollen's off the charts strong, even in the convertible.
New Allegra gel caps. Nothing's faster. Nothing's stronger. Guaranteed or your money back. Visit Allegra.com. Use only as directed.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom, and with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
By now, you may have heard a bit about Bitcoins, but did you know Bitcoins are now over an $8.5 billion market? And did you know that over 65,000 businesses now accept Bitcoins? Listen, if you're already earning Bitcoins or trying to make money in the Bitcoin market, you've got to know BidBit.co. Why? Because BidBit.co is where you can easily receive Bitcoins by selling and auctioning off your own personal items or promote business products and services for Bitcoins. You heard right. Whether personal or business, you can now buy, sell, and auction your products and services quickly, easily, and securely for Bitcoin at BidBit.co, the first and only marketplace website to offer BidBit escrow, a proprietary technology which gives buyers and sellers security and peace of mind because all transactions are protected. Start today. It's free to join, free to post, free to auction, and free to bid at BidBit.co. Buy, sell, bid, or auction everything Bitcoin. That's www.bidbit.co. BidBit.co.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com. LRN.FM needs your help getting our satellite signal back on in Africa. Our satellite provider had us on at no charge from 2012 through February of this year when they pulled the channel off the air. Now we're trying to raise $22,000 to continue reaching people with the message of liberty in places where it's needed most. Please visit our Indiegogo fundraiser at africa.lrn.fm. Give what you can and share the link with your friends. africa.lrn.fm.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Moments remain, but enough time for you. If you dial now to 855-450-FREE, that's the toll-free number, 855-450-3733. Don't forget, you can also join us via Skype. Skype username is lrn.fm. And we're going to jump into your calls here in a moment, talking about the Batgirl cover controversy. Also, want to let you know about our fundraiser that's going on right now, the Africa Satellite Fundraiser. You go to africa.lrn.fm. And you can contribute to help us get back on in Africa. We were on since mid 2012 through February of this year, gratis. The satellite provider that I pay monthly for to get our signal on over North and Central America had given me a free trial on an African satellite. I, of course, said yes. And they never took us off. They were supposed to take us off the free trial after 2 months. They didn't. They say they forgot. I don't know what the real story is. I think they might have actually put us there to make it look like they actually had some channels so they could sell other channels in the space because it was a new satellite. But regardless, the free ride ended last month. They pulled the station off the air. And I'd like to get it back because we actually have African listeners. I mean, there were people who had reached out to the show to let us know, like Akko, who's called in a number of times from Cameroon, to let us know they listen and they appreciate the content that we're putting out there on LRN.
He puts together a discussion group about these ideas in wherever, I guess, around his town in Cameroon. He would call in. He had to, take a two-hour bus ride to just get
40
on the...
40 kilometers.
40 kilometers.
Yeah.
To just get on the... Be able to use the phone or the Skype in order to call in.
That's correct. So, we've learned a lot from those conversations, and I know they've been learning from listening to LRN.fm. So I'd like to get LRN back on, and I'd like to get your help. If you appreciate Akko's calls and you like... the idea that we're getting the message of liberty into some of the least free places in the world. These people don't have internet access in many cases. And that's why the satellite signal is so important, because the government can't stop that signal. They can stop the internet towers from being put up or whatever, or stop cable lines from being run, but they can't jam a satellite signal. They just can't do it. So it's important to me, and so please step forward, go to africa.lrn.fm. There's some perks involved, but generally, I want most all this money to go to actually buy satellite time, and so far we're closing in on the first $1,000 mark, which I'm really happy about. We've got all of 8 people who have contributed so far, and if you don't have $10 or $5 or whatever that you can throw into this, I'd appreciate if you do. But if you don't, then just please share the video. Grab the video from the top of the fundraiser at africa.lrn.fm. Copy the video link and then share that out, or share africa.lrn.fm. Share that on your social networking. I think, Mark, I've never done this before. We've never done an Indiegogo fundraiser or anything like this. And so far, the video that pitches this, it's a 4-minute video, so it's certainly within the YouTube, short attention span time frame. Usually 2 to 5 minutes is what you want your videos to be. It's only got 180 views so far, 181 views. You
would have expected it to go farther than that, huh?
Well, no, not necessarily. I would expect that the more views it gets, the more donations we'll get, however.
Agreed.
So to have gotten almost $1,000 out of only 181 views, I feel like that's actually pretty good. So, I mean, I'd like to see it, you know, get a few thousand views. You know, obviously, if it went viral, that'd be really nice. But
people can go see it at africa.lrn.fm.
Yeah, please do. And please share it. That's one of the most important things, because these
things. And we're also taking Bitcoin.
Yep, that's right. I haven't checked the Bitcoin totals yet. But let's go to Jeff. He's in Chicago listening actually out of WRNN in Elgin. Go ahead, Jeff.
Hi, thanks a lot, you guys. You were talking about comic strips. I was at this library in North Aurora the other day, and I saw a book called The Secret History of Wonder Woman, and I just was looking it up on YouTube while you guys were, while I was on hold. And basically, the Wonder Woman was created. Okay, Margaret Sanger gets involved in it. She, of course, was the head of Planned Parenthood and an abortion. And so the people who created Wonder Woman, the guy, they were people with, I guess you could say, left-wing views. They were like into partner swapping. It started out where Margaret Sanger's niece was like a baby. And okay, she was living with her sister, and their sister's baby was thrown into the snow by the drunken father when he came home. So these were people with very screwed up lives that started a lot of these things. And I mean, it was just interesting how it was all intertwined with Wonder Woman, because we all, I mean, you and I would probably think of Wonder Woman as a beautiful all-American girl, and yet the people behind it were trying to, with Amazon, right, they were trying to promote, you know, feminism and a lot of it, they were trying to promote not being married and not having families. One, the little girl ended up, when she grew up, she had children from another woman's husband, and it was all a big mess. But
well,
anyway.
I can tell you a lot of heroes, if you look at both Batman and Superman, are orphans, as is Captain America and Peter Parker, the Spectacular Spider-Man. I mean, so I guess messed up family lives kind of come with being a hero.
Okay, maybe you got a point there, you know, but I guess what I'm saying is...
Well, just to be clear, were you saying that the messed up family life was Wonder Woman's or the creators of Wonder Woman?
The creators, because she was just like a created, you know, person. She, from what I had seen about her, whenever I saw anything on TV, it didn't seem like she herself was messed up. But I mean, like, the you know, partner swapping and stuff like that, not being like an orphan is to be, you know, that's an accident, you know, to be an orphan. But, you know, people who are adults who are doing partner swapping and things. And
well, what's wrong with that?
Well, you know,
it was probably more uncommon in the 30s.
Yeah, it probably was.
Was it? I mean, I don't know. I mean,
I don't
it
either.
Just wasn't talked about.
It was not, you know, probably would have raised more eyebrows at that time, you know.
Mm-hmm. It seems like you're passing judgment on you know, people's sexual proclivities or preferences, and that's, you know, certainly you're free to do that. But I don't doubt that
Wonder Woman was sort of created with a feminist bend to it. No doubt about it. I mean,
yeah.
I don't think
there
just wasn't really a lot of female heroes out there at the time, and I think we needed that. I think that was a good thing.
If you're at the library, check out that, you know, The Secret History of Wonder Woman.
All right,
by
Jeff.
Joel
thanks.
Lepore.
I don't ever go to libraries, but thank you for the call tonight. I appreciate it. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Mark, what else is there to say about this?
Well, I want to ask you is what I thought to be the best critique of this is that that they would never draw a hero being held hostage by a supervillain.
I don't believe that.
Crying. You just don't think that would happen? Do you think that would happen, or what?
I feel like I'm not a comic book aficionado, but I feel like I've seen similar artists or artistry on the, you know, covers of comics with heroes in jeopardy, and, you know, whether they're crying or not, I don't remember that detail, but you've said that it has happened, right? You've said Batman has cried
over
Robin.
Cried
over
Robin being held hostage. I wonder if Robin's cried while being held hostage. I'm just trying to figure this out, with whether any of these critiques are valid. Let me go on. Beyond the actual image, the problems stemming from the cover are myriad. The most obvious is, how did DC let this happen? I applaud DC for choosing to cancel the cover at the artist's request, and I think it's important to point out, but just because the artist wasn't that bold on this subject doesn't mean the rest of us can't be. But it's still insane that this cover was ordered, approved, and going to be printed, with no one at DC ever once thinking, hey, maybe a cover that directly references the time the Joker potentially raped Batgirl might just upset a few people. Now, okay, so upsetting people is probably something that you need to do if you publish literature, right? Like you need the you know, people to be talking about what you're doing and interested in what you're doing, and that's what's exactly happening here. Or, hey, maybe given that we've let Cameron Stewart, Brendan Fletcher, and Babs Tarr try to make a Batgirl that appeals specifically to young female readers, having a cover where it looks like the Joker's about to rape Batgirl is a bad idea. It's great that DC fixed the problem as soon as they realized it was a problem, but eventually DC Comics needs to get to a point where it can identify these issues and prevent them from occurring in the first place, is what the claim is. But you did point out that there are every single cover, Batgirl's in jeopardy in some way or another. Now,
well, not every cover.
Many
I pointed
covers.
Out a few covers where she was in as much, if not more, jeopardy than this current one with controversy.
I guess it just all comes back to this special form of assault that's sexual assault, doesn't it? I mean, that's what it all seems to come back to.
I guess, but she's not being sexually assaulted on the cover, so, I mean, that seems like a big leap.
You think that that's a leap? I mean, you don't think that there's some kind of... I guess. I mean, she could be just held hostage and Joker drawing on her face with marker.
It's just art.
Yeah.
Jeez. All right, so there you go. Mark, you did post the link on Facebook, Google Plus, and Twitter. So
not all the stories, but yeah.
No, but you posted a link to a story about this, which has the cover. So if you want to see what we're talking about, you can go and do that there. We'll be back tomorrow night. You can join us online in the meantime at freetalklive.com.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. Physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
My name is Jacob Hornberger. I'm president of the Future of Freedom Foundation, which Congressman Ron Paul awarded for having an outstanding freedom website. Write us at fff@fff.org, and we'll send you a free 3-month subscription to our monthly journal of libertarian essays and our booklet, Economic Liberty in the Constitution, which George Mason University economics professor Walter Williams praised in a recent column. That's fff@fff.org.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
The live edition of Liberty Conspiracy is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Sunday, March 22nd, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.75 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,183 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $262. Antiwar.com reports, while the Likud party has already claimed victory in this week's elections in Israel, getting enough partners on board for a coalition government is not an easy task, with early talks indicating several factions want the defense portfolio. Avigdor Lieberman promised his supporters he'd take the portfolio after the election and wipe out the entire Gaza Strip. A poor election day showing doesn't appear to have changed his mind, and he's still demanding the spot. So is fellow hawk Naftali Bennett, who is demanding occupying the spot and also wants Netanyahu to assure him that Palestinian statehood will not happen during the current coalition. Moshe Kalon is quite happy to be promised the finance ministry portfolio, but also wants one of his party's members of parliament to get the defense portfolio, reflecting their strong showing in the vote and warning Netanyahu that their backing is not assured. Likud wants the current major portfolios to stay in place, meaning Yalon would remain defense minister, Lieberman would remain finance minister, and Bennett economics minister. Finance ministry is the only major spot changing hands from Yair Lapid, who is headed to the opposition, to Kalon. That's Likud's ideal, at least, but given the long road to getting a 60-seat majority, expect those plans to change and for several different proposals to be floated before everyone is satisfied. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports three South Florida police officers were fired and a fourth resigned over the exchange of racially biased videos and messages, according to officials. Fort Lauderdale Police Department announced on Friday the termination of Chris Sousa, James Wells, and Jason Holding, as well as the resignation of Alex Alvarez. A five-month internal affairs investigation found the officers had exchanged text messages using racially offensive terms in reference to black people encountered in the line of duty, as well as critical comments about the grammar, appearance, and work ethic of black co-workers. The investigation began when Alvarez's ex-fiance came forward with evidence. Dozens of pages of messages revealed text advocating violence towards blacks, while others featured derogatory comments towards Hispanics and homosexuals. According to investigators, Alvarez created a mock video trailer called The Hoods, which featured images of a KKK hood and President Obama with large gold teeth. Fort Lauderdale Police Chief Frank Adderley said the officers worked in a predominantly black community. The Fraternal Order of Police said in a statement on Friday that it is a multicultural organization which does not tolerate racism, but added that everyone is entitled to due process and that these officers have a right to a fair review of facts. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Coinbase. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. I trust Coinbase. You should too. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. That's coinbase.fppradio.com. Reuters reports Iran's top leader voiced mistrust on Saturday of U.S. efforts to reach a nuclear deal, even as Washington and its allies spoke of real progress and urged Tehran to make difficult decisions. With just 10 days remaining until an end-of-March deadline for a framework agreement, Iran's supreme leader Ayatollah Ali Khamenei denounced U.S. bullying in the negotiations and repeated